for the trophies? Do you long for that platinum that you have not yet acquired? Well, look at our co-stars rub it in your fucking face! And after that painstakingly long segment, we have games that matter to you. Destiny 2, Shadow of War, and Crash Bandicoot Insane Trilogy! All of this and more in the next exciting episode of Saturday Night Soundbite! I'm out of here!
Hello, my copious fanboys, and welcome to episode 3 of
Did you just
Saturday.
Assume their gender?
Oh, here we go. Here we go with your stupid gender shit, Jack. You listen to me right now. If you think we care about these multinationals watching this incredibly sophisticated podcast, I will wring your chicken's head and make it answer itself. Welcome to episode 3
speaking...
of Saturday Night Soundbite.
Oh, will you shut the fuck up, Jacob?
Sorry,
and,
Dad.
And today we have a podcast for you like every week, because if we didn't do it 3 weeks in a row and we gave up on it within 2 weeks, then we wouldn't be very good people, would we? I'm going to shut up and get on with it now. Hello, how's everyone been doing?
Doing fantastic, Keith. Absolutely fantastic.
That's nice. How about you, Jack?
Oh, I've been doing just swell, you know?
But what have you been playing
just
recently?
Swell.
Actually, no, before we do that, we nearly forgot to do it again. we meant to do this at the start of the first episode, then we forgot, then we tried to do it at the start of the second episode, and we forgot. But we're doing it this time without fail. If you have any questions for us at all, any questions about...
To answer on the show.
To answer that you want us to answer on the show or anywhere, then just leave them in the comments below, and we will do our very best to ignore them. So, yeah, that's that out of the way. So Jack, what have you been doing?
Well, I've been you know, on a little bit of a trophy binge. So I've been playing through Jack 2, and I'm going to try to platinum that game. All I need is the precursor orb trophies. Same thing for Jack 3, and then I'll have 5 platinums, and then I promise I'm done with platinums, and I'm just gonna not.
Yeah, we've been through that. Me and Nick have been through.
Yeah,
that. I got the 10 platinums. I was like, yeah, that's it. I'm done. I'm happy with that. Then I got the 20. I was like, yeah, I'm done. I'm happy with that. Now I'm at fucking 40, and I'm like, I might as well just go for 50, you know?
Will you ever get to 100?
No. I'm done at 50, that's it. That's it.
Oh, so upset.
Get to 69. Get to 69.
That'd just annoy me then, that I don't have 70. But, are you gonna platinum them legitimately, or are you gonna do the orb glitch?
I might try to platinum Jack 3 legitimately,
oh,
but...
Jack 3 is harder to platinum, in my opinion.
You think so?
Yeah, it's
the worst
one. Yeah.
Well, yeah. I don't know. I played through the I was playing through the Blaster Challenge on Jack 2, trying to like get the gold. And like after going through it a few times and not even being able to get silver, I was like, fuck this shit, I'm gonna cheat, essentially.
Try doing it with no hands. Okay. How about you, Nick? How have you been doing?
Oh, I've been doing rather well, Keith. Rather well indeed. So let's see here. So because I live in a state that is completely 100% legal, I got really toasted last night. Well, actually a few nights, like two fucking nights. Watched a lot of shit. Started watching The Lord of the Rings.
Image. I just have an image of you sitting in a toaster watching Lord of the Rings.
Oh yeah, totally sitting in a toaster. Mm-hmm. Yeah, getting that nice crispy brown. Yeah, while I watch fucking Legolas with an arrow.
It should be a toaster that is inside a in a bathtub with Nick also in the bathtub.
Mm-hmm, yeah. You know, that reminds me of that Game Informer thing with Hitman back on PS2 with the girl in the bathtub with the roses and the fucking thing in the dresser, and you could see Hitman, you could see Agent, whatever the fuck his name is,
47.
47, yeah, that's the number. Anyway, so yeah, I have been watching a little bit of The Lord of the Rings here and there. Currently playing a crack in time, trying to get through it. Got 3 trophies left, got to get the gold bolts, and then complete the game on hard, basically, and that'll have all the...
Oh, you should have done that from the start, you fucking idiot.
Oh yeah, well, you know, tough luck.
Good thing you don't. Good thing you don't have to get all the skill points.
Yeah, that's a very, very, very good thing, because some of those skill points are like fucking crackpot. Like, seriously,
what are they used like, for? Just cheats?
Yeah, just dumbass cheats, really. Ratchet and Clank has never really been.
Crackpots. You seem very on edge there, Nick. Do not want to like sit down and relax because we're going to be here a while.
Nah. I'd rather pace for about 4 hours. It's fine.
Nick, are you on the shitter?
No, I'm not on the shitter. I'm not on the shitter.
Speaking of the shitter. Never go to bed with the only thing you've eaten all day is 8 reheated Burger King chicken nuggets.
Are you fucking dumb?
It was the only thing in the fridge, and I didn't feel like cooking something, fam.
Okay. All right. Anyway, yeah. So, Keith, speaking of potatoes, what have you been doing?
Okay, Nick. Well, speaking of potatoes, as you said, I have. I was sitting down in my bed about after the last podcast, pretty much immediately after the last podcast, thinking about, oh, I have a big day ahead of me editing this thing, and right. I was just thinking to myself, and I was like, you know what I'd love? You know what'd be really cool right now? I'd love to have a 3DS in my hands and play it right now. So, does this urgent go away? It was like, it got to Friday.
Why do you want 3Ds and an S?
So, it got to Friday, and I was in the middle of uploading the, I was in the middle of uploading the podcast, and I was like, fuck it. I still want a 3DS, and I have no idea why. So, I was like, okay, sorry, I accidentally opened the program, and I don't know how to close it. Oh my god, Cody, fuck off. Jesus Christ, thank you. But, I still had this feeling that I really wanted to play a 3DS, and I just wanted the 3DS in my hand. So I was like, you know what, fuck it. So I got together €250, my life savings, and went and bought one. And at first I kind of regretted it. I was like, oh no, why did I buy this thing? I have no fucking games. And I was like, wait a second, this is a Nintendo console. And you know what a Nintendo console means, don't you?
Nintendo. Easy to hack.
Oh, hell yeah. Easy to hack. So yeah,
5 hours later.
5 hours later, I hacked the shit out of this motherfucker. I made everything on the eShop completely free, and I proceeded to download every game I wanted.
So Keith, I'm really, really touched by your willingness to just talk about your fucking crimes open like this. It's really now, touching.
It's not really a crime. It's Nintendo. It's their own fault. What other console lets you hack every single... What other company lets you hack every single one of their fucking consoles in complete ease?
Like, complete I hear the PSP is pretty easy to do.
Well, the PSP is ancient, and it took how many years for people to actually find like custom firmware that would actually not brick the console? Like, it was a really long process to get that. But yeah. With the 3DS, like the minute a Nintendo console comes out, people are working on homebrew for it, and it's their own fault. Like, I give you 3 months, and the Switch will be fucking hacked. But getting on with that, to the games I downloaded. So the first thing that I wanted to play,
you mean the games you bought?
Oh, yeah, of course, the game's like completely legally bought.
Just like that weed I legally smoked.
Exactly. The first thing I got was the Phoenix Wright trilogy. Anyone familiar with the Phoenix Wright games here?
Yeah, I've never played them, but I've seen a lot about them. They seem pretty interesting.
Yeah, they're awesome. They're so cool. It's pretty much you're a lawyer and you solve cases, and it's what it sounds. And you go around solving cases. It's a visual novel, very weird characters, batshit insane Japanese stuff. But it's just so fun. And yeah, it's a game I've wanted to get back since I didn't break my old 3DS. I just like I don't know what happened to it. It's just gone. So yeah, it's a game I've wanted to get back since then.
Keith, yo. Forgot to mention. Speaking of hardware, I managed to get my hands on 2 Xbox 360s for free.
Basically. Nice. How?
DJ had 4 of the fuckers.
Who's DJ?
And DJ would be known as the 19-year-old man-child-child-man thing that lives across the hall from me who plays video games for a living. Yeah, he's a mantelope. Anyways, he had a spare one, and he was also gracious to allow me to use one of them. One of them has the red ring of death, but has a perfect casing, while the other one has a little bit of crack.
That's why he gave it to you.
Hey, hold this for me, okay? Don't use
hold this for me. I'll be gone for the next 2 weeks, right?
So I'm gonna take the casing off the other one and put the fresher casing on it, and I'll be able to play stuff like Red Dead Redemption, Dead Space 2. I guess I'll be able to experience Minecraft on fucking Xbox. Like, that's gonna make any difference.
Hold up. He plays games for a living. So he's basically what Keith aspires to be.
Actually, more or less, he just lives and plays games.
Oh, okay. Big difference there.
Yeah, big. He big wants difference. To do it, though. He wants to do it.
Does he have a YouTube channel?
Yeah, you want to hear the name?
Oh, God, he has one? Okay.
Possible.
Hey, he has to pay us for advertising.
Yeah, so what's his name?
It would be known as the legendary and mysterious, unknown to man because it doesn't have any traction, known as DJ Psycho Gamer.
DJ Psycho, that's not the worst I've ever heard, honestly.
I mean, yeah, I've heard a stuff. Lot.
That's fine. That's not too bad. Yeah. Like, if he ever did blow up, I'd have no problem with that name. Like, hey guys, this is DJ Psycho Gamer. It'd just be like that.
Hey guys, what's up? It's another video from DJ Psycho Gamer here again, once again bringing you another giveaway video where I'm going to be whoring away my entire family.
The sad thing though, is that even if he wanted to, though, I don't think he'd be able to give a presentation like that. Lisps and shit like that, you know.
So I have a lisp. I get over it. I have a stammer and a lisp, so I can go through it. See?
Yeah, but anyways, enough about that. We sponsored him. Let's continue on.
Yeah, go on. So, you're looking forward to playing Red Dead. Good luck to playing that for 3 minutes while your Xbox cooks itself alive.
Why would you say that?
Is it a first-gen Xbox?
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, good luck with that. You're going to last, about 3 minutes.
Really? I wonder why.
We're
not really fanboys of the Xbox here. I mean, come on. I'm just going to put this system on and try to experience it with the most unbiased opinion that I possibly can.
When you turn it on, it will probably start, you'll probably be able to fry eggs on the fucking thing. How old is it?
Honestly, I don't mean to sound like a dick, right? But this thing has far better air fucking flow than the fucking PS3.
It has more vents in it. It has more holes in it because it needs more holes. Because it cooks itself a fucking life.
That's true. I mean, let's give it some credit here. It is the first generation console of that time. It did come out in 2005.
Very revolutionary console. First online, fully online console. First pioneered online game. And yeah, I have a lot of respect for the Xbox 360 software.
We can't bash it too much. But
I have no respect for the hardware whatsoever.
Oh, no. Actually, I really don't like the software either.
Really?
No. I find it to be very convoluted. Very convoluted, the menu, which is why I'm glad I'm actually going to be able to, take my time and you know, really dig into the system and see, just how bad it is, you know. I mean, and see if there's some good, because there is some good things on it. There's some applications and stuff that you can only get being a Microsoft consumer. So, you know, it will broaden horizons. If anything, this is
Horizon on Xbox confirmed.
Oh, you heard it here, folks! Right on Saturday Night Soundbite. Horizon coming to third-party consoles near you.
Generation third-party consoles at
last.
That.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Running at a smooth 60 frames per second.
Running at a smooth 15 and a half frames per second.
And then smooth in asterisks.
with PS2 graphics.
May not be smooth if your eyesight is above the quality of your average 88-year-old.
All right. I think we've talked about enough of what we've been doing.
That's interesting, though. Let me just finish saying what I was playing. Where was I? Oh, yeah, Phoenix Wright. I was playing Phoenix Wright. I love those games to death. Everyone should play them if you have access to the games. Get an emulator and play them on an NES emulator, good man. I've also downloaded Super Mario Brothers 2. No, new Super Mario Brothers 2. Apologies. Honestly, it's the best new Super Mario Brothers game yet. I enjoy it. I've played all of them. I've played the DS one. I've played the Wii one and the Wii U one. And this one is... they're pretty much all the same game, but this one has actually tried to change some things, and I really appreciate that, and it's really fun, really enjoying it. And finally, I've been playing a lot, well, not a lot, I've had it for a few days, but I've been playing some of Dr. Kawamashima's Brain Training. Do you want to guess my brain age here? I think I told you earlier, but maybe you forget.
80.
69.
My brain is 80 years old. And I played some Brain Age, and Dr. Kawamashima, in fairness to him, he was very supportive, and he said to me, "Your brain is shit, mate, but we can fix it, just keep playing me." And I did, and I got it down to...
Now...
I forgot to turn off my PS4, and I got it down to 60.
For 80-year-olds, is their brain really just functioning a lot less, or is their body just not as good at communicating?
I think he said my brain was the age of an 80-year-old, so... He said, like, the top brain age is 20. So I guess it's bad. I don't know.
I mean, it's better than being 5.
I guess. True. And Nick, can I ask you a question? Because it's kind of bothering me.
What, Keith?
Why are you on PS4?
What?
I just saw you come on. You can't hide from me. I left my PS4 and I got a notification saying Nick Souza is now online.
Yes, we're going to start to...
You're busted. Busted, bitch.
When you're trophy hunting while you're doing a podcast.
Well, I got to get those numbers up.
Explain to us, Nick. Quarters in session.
Okay. I will explain.
Well, go on. For listening. Hello? Oh, Nick, don't kill yourself. It was a joke.
That.
What?
That.
That. What's that?
What? Look at your fucking tap. Look at your Skype tap, would you?
Look at my tap? My Skype? I didn't get any notification from Skype.
Oh, trophies.
Oh, okay. You're showing us.
I was getting that ready.
Oh, you're preparing. Okay, I'll let you off this time.
Oh, I don't have my PS4 plugged in, but I have my PS3 plugged
in. It's fine, Jack. If you go to a website called PlayStationTrophies.org, you'll be able to look at everyone's trophies without accessing a PlayStation. So.
Ooh, okay.
Yes. But going on, yes, I've also been playing some Dr. Kawamashima's Brain Training. My brain is shit, but I'm fixing it. So maybe I could be a lot more eloquent and articulate in the next few podcasts. I won't sound like a complete... So that's that, and that's what I have been playing.
You're still a Mick, so it's going to be like that anyway.
Well, Dr. Kawamashima is Japanese, so maybe I could get some of his Japanese brawn in my
Ooh,
brain.
True.
So that's that. Anyone have anything to add before we go on to our special news segment?
Let's move on to the news segment.
That's what you have to add. Let's move on to the news segment. Okay. Time for the news. That's more of an ambulance, which I'm going to end it is.
Wee-woo.
So who wants to start us off with the news?
I guess I will, Keith.
You're the one with all the articles, Keith.
Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah. Okay, Nick, then you go.
Alright. So here's my article.
It is called, Cite your source, Nick. Cite your source.
It is called... It is from... Xenobyte Post.
Oh!
Oh, really?
Guess who doesn't have a news article? You will not believe who it is.
Oh, that's clickbait. I'm gonna guess.
Yeah, I don't have a fucking news article at all. No, your turn, Keith.
How about you, Jack? Do you have a news article, or am I gonna be a lone man here?
You're gonna be pretty alone.
God damn it.
There's no one
on. My shit together. God damn you guys. Okay, sorry. News time. Right then. Let me start off with this one. WrestleMania 33 set looks fucking insane. Have anyone? Of course you haven't, but I'm gonna send you a picture of WrestleMania 33 set so far. Yeah, they're building a fucking roller coaster. It's a WrestleMania 33 set. I don't know if it's gonna be a functional roller coaster, but the set itself is like in the shape of a roller coaster, and it looks like, oh my, it looks astonishing. Also, they're building a ring, like a giant ring, on top of the actual ring. So we know exactly what Shane McMahon's going to jump off now. And yeah, it's something I want to bring up because it looks awesome, and I'm so looking forward to WrestleMania this Sunday. I'm very looking forward to it. That's great English, Keith. Yes, it's amazing. Amazing set. The set is like half of WrestleMania for me. Like, that's what I look forward to, like half, like mostly. Most
holy years. Cow!
Yeah, that's exactly gonna be my reaction when I see the roller coaster. I hope it. Imagine it's a fucking working roller coaster. Imagine how insane that would be. Fucking wrestling matches going on while roller coaster is fucking flying around them. Like, holy shit. That'd be quite distracting.
I'm the roller coaster wrestling.
Shane McMahon could jump off the roller coaster while it's moving.
Yeah, think about it. If it's going around in a circle, right? And Shane's on it, right? And you know, you got your other guy who he just beat to a pulp, you know, sitting there like, when it's coming around the bend towards him, he's probably going to jump off of it at high velocity and tackle him into a fucking table.
Yes, that's very possible. But yeah, we'll see. We'll see Sunday night. And Nick, I haven't got a straight answer from you yet. Will you be watching WrestleMania?
I'll be watching The Undertaker's demise.
Well, we don't know if it's his last match yet. It's just speculation. I mean, I will tell you if it's going to be The Undertaker's last match. If this match is not on before halfway through the show, and it is the main event, it's the Undertaker's last match. That's what I'll say to you. So I'll let you know while I'm watching it whether it's not it's going to be Undertaker's last match.
Oh, if you tell me it's the last match, he's been under speculation, then there's no point in watching it. It's like fucking sports. There's no point if I know the outcome.
What are you talking about?
If I know the outcome, if I know who's going to win, there's no point in watching it.
It doesn't matter. Like, no, you don't know who's going to win if I say it's The Undertaker's last match. It's the same as that. If it's The Undertaker's last match, how do you know who's going to win?
Because wouldn't you want to put him in the grave or something like that? Like, wouldn't that be more towards his character?
True, but like, WWE does a lot of weird shit, so you never know. But yeah, that's that. That's that news story. Short and sweet. Just wanted to get it out of the way. And then I have one more. Guards have been very bold in Ireland. I don't know if you lads have heard about this. Of course you haven't. You're fucking American and nothing exists outside America. But
exactly.
Where's Ireland? Is that in, like, Africa?
Saudi Arabia. The people you were at war with.
Don't those guys live in giant potatoes?
I thought that was India.
No, I
was born in cabbage. What was that thing about Jaina? Can't forget Jaina.
China.
Yeah. With their wallet.
China. but anyway, the guards have been bold in Ireland. Do you want to hear what our fucking Garda have been up to?
Oh, what have they been up to?
So firstly, they have falsely breathalyzed, found people guilty of drink driving by falsely breathalyzing over a million of them.
Can we just take a moment to like. Admire your speech. Keep drink driving.
Is that not a known phrase? That's the that's the official like corporate phrase for drinking while under the influence here. Drink driving.
What seems to be the problem, Ossifer?
Maybe anyway, if everybody in Ireland talks like Keith, that's why. They're maybe. Like, you know what? Yeah, maybe
it's drink driving, right? But you
basically the cops have pretty much framed over a million people by pretending that they failed a breathalyzer test when they didn't.
There's a million people in Ireland, Keith.
Oh, shut up. and that's a big controversy at the moment, and people have to be all reimbursed with their fines and all. But also, the guards have spent thousands of fines, like money from fines, on jewelry, flowers, and a golf society.
What?
Concerns about widespread financial irregularities at the Garda College were first expressed over a decade ago. A damning internal audit has been revealed. Bank accounts were often used for purposes other than those for which they were intended, including buying gifts, spending on entertainment, and the sponsorships of Garda sports clubs. Miss O'Sullivan, who was the Garda main honcho, whatever, said that a sum of €124,903 was collected in rent from farmers for the use of land called Dramad Farm between 2009 and 2013. And this money was used to play golf, apparently. The Exodus are being put under question and blah, blah, blah. I'm not going to read much into that, but yeah, it literally breaks down. Like, okay, here's a good one. In 2008, a laundry account was used to pay for a $500 staff bonus, €500 staff bonus, meals, and an entertainment that was worth €7,231. Jewelry and gifts were €300. Flowers were €200, as well as contributions to the local Garda boat club, which was €500. A golf society, which was €1,040, and a parish clergy, which was €2,150, so they're donating money to the church now, apparently, and multiple charities, which they gave €3,000 to. So yeah, the guards have been being guards. Huh. As always, lads. And that's my news stories. Anything to add, my friends?
Wonderful. Let's move on.
You're very, why are you so on the edge today, Nick? We're only 25 minutes in. You gotta relax. You gotta relax,
so,
man.
So, I've been on psnprofiles.com.
Uh-huh.
And, you know, Keith, you're rank 519th for the most trophies in Ireland.
What? Are you insane?
Yes, he couldn't be that high up on the list. There's only 10 people there.
Holy, no, that's actually quite shocking.
For the world... You're 74,000.
Yeah, well, whatever. That's the word. But Ireland, I'm 500? Really?
519, yes.
You know how many? There's 6 million people in Ireland, and I'm in the top 500. I'm quite proud of that.
The guy, let's see. Wow, all of these guys are level 20s. Level 20 must be a hard threshold to beat, man.
Oh, it is. Once you get to level 20, I'm a level 21.
Oh, Jesus Christ. The guy who's number one is a level 63.
Oh, God. Wait.
He has 376 platinums. What? And he's number one in Ireland, but he's only 389th in the world.
That's not a bad number now, in fairness.
Yeah. I mean, we got motherfuckers with 10,000 bronze trophies and shit like that.
I mean,
it's more than I have trophies. Ooh, one of these guys has a number 34 in Ireland has a dark jack is their picture. So.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That's cool. Gotta represent.
Shout out to you, Neurothic_Seth.
Let us change our PSN names. Fucking hell.
And your 144 platinum trophies?
That is not much at all.
Oh, Jesus. Keith, you know, you've earned 2.39 trophies per day.
Oh, that's bad. That's actually quite depressing.
Really? I'm at 0.68.
Yeah, well, you're not really like... Let me have a look at your profile. Let's do the segment now. Welcome to the... Inspect each other's trophy cabinet segment. So I'm going to go to psnprofiles.com. What's your PSN name, Jackalus?
Gutshot Jack.
Yeah.
Gutshot. Oh, Gutshot Jack. Gutshot.
Oh, God. I've got 1,786 trophies, 3 platinums. I've got 67 golds, 353 silvers, and 1,363 bronzes.
Yes, I see. You have a total of 36.92% completion.
Whatever that means.
That's not bad. Overall completion of all games you've ever played is 36%.
Oh, okay. I mean, considering my brother's like launched some sports games on here, which have like 0 trophies, that kind of makes me mad, but whatever.
You can delete them.
Your world rank, 283,424.
Really, it says my world rank is 336,000.
Where are you? What site are you on?
PSNprofiles.com.
That's where I am.
What the heck? Refresh your page, bro.
Refreshing now.
I'd love to.
283,424. That's what it's saying.
Oh shit. Okay, I just refreshed, and yeah, I guess you're right.
You went up in the space of a few seconds.
I finally got 80,000, my 50 fucking 1,000 or whatever. Okay.
And your country rank is 89,755. So
I'll take that. You're
in the top 90,000. Sly 2, Band of Thieves. Ah, come on. Jackalus.
Why?
10%. 7 out of 36 trophies in Sly 2. Sly 2? Did you finish Sly 2?
Apparently I haven't. I could swear that I have.
Did you sink your trophies?
Maybe not.
Oh, there you go. Oh, Jack. 7 trophies in Ratchet 3. Are you... What? Come on, Matt.
I completed that game.
You need to hang your... 7 trophies. Yeah, Ratchet doesn't give you any trophies. Like you, because like 7 trophies for completing it. That's inexcusable. Just inexcusable. If you don't have a Ratchet 3 Platinum by next week, you're not on the podcast. You go work on that right now.
What a death sentence.
I'm being 100% serial, by the way. Okay, here we go. You've redeemed yourself. Ratchet and Clank on the PlayStation 4. You have all 47 trophies. You got an S rank for it. You got 100% of the trophies.
It took me 1 week and 3 days.
Yeah. That's not
pretty
bad
accurate. That's pretty accurate.
And I was only really trying to platinum it for like 3 days.
Grand Theft Auto 5, 1 trophy. Well done.
That's PS4.
PS4. Okay. Last of Us Remastered, 4 trophies. I can relate with that. That game gives you no fucking trophies.
Oh, like, wait until you get to Last of Us PS3.
I think he's at like 36%.
You know what, motherfucker? It's 20 out of 50 trophies for Last of Us PS3, okay? That's a fucking A rank.
Okay. Last of Us is a ridiculous platinum. It's just stupid platinum. GTA V on PlayStation 3, 31 out of 59. Not bad. Not bad. I think that's actually more than me. Ratchet Deadlocked, 13 trophies. Ratchet 2, 6 trophies. Ratchet 1, 14 trophies. Ah, Jack! What are you at with your life? Do other things, how dare you? You need to be platinum in games. This is inexcusable.
I know, man. I'm basically a normie.
Do you want to hear something? You have more trophies in Call of Duty Black Ops. No, in Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3 than you do in Ratchet and Clank. How do you explain this?
Well, Call of Duty...
Do you, Jack, MW3, tell us, let us know right here now.
It has more trophies. It has like a bunch more trophies.
Stop
avoiding
the question, Jack.
They basically give you trophies for free in that game.
Stop like, avoiding the question,
you watch,
Jack.
You finish like the first cutscene.
Stop avoiding
like,
the question,
have trophy.
Jack. Stop avoiding the question. Do you prefer Call of Duty over Ratchet and Clank?
Oh, fuck no.
Okay, that's all as well. Last of Us PS3, 20 out of 50. Not bad. Not bad at all.
Yeah. I think I have a multiplayer gold on there because I really liked the multiplayer for that game.
Not bad. Ratchet into the Nexus, 12 out of 23 trophies. You could platinum that game with your eyes closed.
Could you?
Well, probably not technically, but Nick done it, so it can't be that hard. Slice.
Yeah, you dummy.
Thieves in Time, I can understand that's a dickhead of a platinum. Dishonored, 0, I'm the same. Star Wars The Force Unleashed, 25, not bad. Okay, here we go, we're getting interested now. Ratchet and Clank, A Crack in Time, 31 out of 37 trophies. You can get on that. I get best you're missing the Blaster Runs Hot Trophy and a few of the miscellaneous ones, but you can get on that. You can get that platinum done.
Yeah, I don't doubt it.
Assassin's Creed Unity, 61%, really? You liked Assassin's Creed Unity by the looks of it?
Not really.
It was a good game.
I mean, it was a pretty decent game. I liked the I thought the combat was some of the best in the series because it wasn't just move the analog stick and kill everything.
Yeah, instead it was just a monotony of fencing matches.
Yeah, but I mean, you know, how are you gonna do like good dynamic sword fighting without it being like that? That's for somebody smarter than me to figure out.
Jack and Daxter, The Precursor Legacy. Never heard of this game before. You have 100% in it. Apparently you liked it.
Yeah, I did.
Oh, fuck off. Is that you again, Nick? No, it's someone else. Let me just turn this off. I can't find my remote. I will do that some other time. Okay, not bad. You like that Jack and Dexter game. Jack 2. Oh, 80%. You're so close. What's stopping you?
Well, I gotta get the Precursor Orbs.
Oh, fair enough. Is that it?
Do I gotta get Skull Gems?
Yeah, you gotta get 510.
Oh, at the same time or in total?
I don't think it's cumulative.
No. You need to get 510. Yeah, correct. And it is a cumulative. Just get him on one save game. You just have to get him on one save game.
Just go to fucking the House of Mar. Go to that part where those fucking jumpy things come at you nonstop and just fucking decimate them, basically.
And then the rest of the trophies are just orb trophies. There's like 5 of them. So it's alright.
Yeah, I just need 3 more of those.
Yeah. So that's that. Jack Tree is missing here. We'll find it eventually. DBC Raging Blast 2.
For me, Jack. Oh, no. Wait. Yeah, where the fuck's Jack 3? Never mind. Go on.
Raging Blast 2, you have 64%. Nice, it's not bad. Destiny, 8 out of 61 trophies. Did you like Destiny?
I mean, it's a decent game to, like, mindlessly, like, listen to a podcast to. Hey!
We have a lot of Destiny fans here.
Oh, yeah. But other than that, like the story is, like, you have to go out of your way to find any story, which people who have gone out of their way, like to the website and stuff like that, they're like, oh yeah, it's they're like, oh, it's actually a pretty decent story. But it's like, I'm good.
Effort.
Yeah.
AC4 Black Flag, 65%. Awesome game. Awesome ranking.
Yeah. I wanted to platinum that at one point.
So do I.
Actually, I found out something. I actually have the potentiality to platinum that game. I don't need to do 100%. If anyone wants to help me out with that, let me know.
Oh, the fucking online trophy. Sorry, I got a fuck. Oh, that's it. That's right. That's why I didn't platinum it, now I think of it.
Yeah, the online trophies are cancer. Are the servers really down? It's fucking impossible at this point.
I think what servers do they use?
Because Ubisoft servers.
Because, like, the only cunty trophy that I literally have left is just to get up to rank 55. And if we just spam that shit and just talk throughout the whole thing, we'd be done.
I will check that for you now, actually. AC4 servers.
I gotta play it on PS3, too.
Oh, God, I'm not doing it on PS3. AC4, the servers get shut down. Oh, God, it's from 2016. Someone's asking it. I don't know. I have no answers. Hopefully, just still up. I'll check that later on. Let's continue. Infamous 82%. Not bad. I got to like 90-something% in Infamous, and I couldn't find the last fucking Blashard.
Yeah, I was thinking about platinuming that game, but you know, nah.
Jetpack Joyride 4%. That's actually a really fun game.
Yeah, I have it on my phone. I used to play it a lot when I was in middle school in 9th grade on my phone.
Jack Tree, here we go. 44 out of, you're missing 2 trophies, you poor bastard.
Yeah, those would be 300 and 600 precursor orbs, yeah.
And the platinum.
Yeah.
Borderlands 2, 4%.
Oh god, Borderlands, New Vegas, terrible. 62%.
I wish I would have platinumed Fallout New Vegas. I love that game.
You literally can still do it.
Yeah, but I don't know. I play it on PC if I play it at all anymore. And, like, the load times are just, like, you know what I mean?
It's the best load times. Fallout 3, you are missing 13 trophies only.
Yeah, no, oh, I'm really...
We've already looked over that one.
Really?
You have to get good karma, neutral karma, and bad karma up to fucking 30.
Oh, I already have good karma, I believe.
Yeah, you have good karma, but that you're still going to do everything else.
Yeah.
I'm just looking for anything more interesting. Oh, platinum. Sly Cooper and the TV's Raccoonus. So,
easiest known as... platinum ever.
also known as Sly Raccoon in Europe, which is the worst name ever because he's not a fucking raccoon.
That is pretty bad. I was going to try to platinum Red Dead Redemption, but it's literally fucking 91 trophies.
Yeah, just online trophies and shit. They're the bane of my existence.
Yeah, that and...
Online trophies should not be compulsory. Yeah, they really shouldn't.
Why is this game sure. Saboteur? You seem to like it a lot. 74%.
See, when the PlayStation 3 first came out, like that game, it was one of the first games where it almost had like the Ubisoft formula, but it was like in Nazi occupied France, and you got to like blow shit up and, you know, be a cool Irishman fighting Nazis and stuff.
Oh, cool. Never even heard of it.
Yeah, no, it was a really good game. I tried playing it earlier this year. It didn't really hold up very well, but, you know, you get into it and you'll like it. Maybe.
92% in Assassin's Creed 2. Let me guess, it's the Fetters.
I believe so, yeah. I've gotten so close to playing so many games, but then just didn't.
Batman Arkham Asylum, this is interesting. What'd you think of that?
I thought that was a pretty good game. I've never brought myself to finish it, though.
I finished it on PS4. It was a very fun game. I'd never gone to platinum it though, because there's like a billion fucking Riddler challenges in it that I'm never going to do. But other than that, I think it's an easy enough platinum.
Google is your friend.
Yeah, fuck that. I just don't. There's like fucking like there's literally like 5,000 of them or something. Not really, but you know, 500 more like. And then there's a fuckload of sports games, and that's it. Yeah, interesting trophy list, Jack.
Yeah.
A bit more grinding and having no life. You could become a trophy hunter.
All right, Keith.
I could. I'm at three. I'm gonna get to five platinums, and then I'm done with platinums. Not gonna get any more.
Oh, okay. We'll see how the addiction hits you.
All right. So.
Time to roll. Now me, I see.
Now we have Keith Healy. Keith Bandicoot.
What?
NG. NG.
Let me change my PSN name, you fucks.
What's the NG stand
it's
for?
It's a typo. It's Sosie ND.
Keith Bandicoot Nig.
All right.
So Keith Bandicoot Nig.
211 games. It says 29 completed games and then 37 platinum, so I don't know which to believe.
So he is a level 21. Keith is a level 20. 4% in. 4% in with 3,789 total trophies, 2,800 bronze, 696 silvers, 195 golds, and 39 platinums. Let's take a look inside. Let's see.
I need to resync Keith's because you said different numbers than I saw.
Yeah. All right, so let's go to the top of the list. Ooh, we got a bunch of good ones here. Ratchet and Clank, A Crack in Time, 100%. Ratchet and Clank 3, up your arsenal, 100%. Ratchet and Clank 2, 100%. Ratchet and Clank Into the Nexus, 100%. Battlefield Hardline Trophies, 8%. Okay, understandable. Ratchet and Clank, 100%.
Anything that has Ratchet and Clank in the title other than All for One or Full Frontal Assault, it's a platinum.
Why not? Yeah. Why not Full Frontal Assault? Yeah.
Because that's the worst Ratchet game ever made.
Damn.
Yeah, worse than All for One, and I actually liked All for One, so.
So we got Grand Theft Auto 4, I meant 5V,
twice.
31% on PS4, 1 silver, 28 bronze.
You only have 2 of Ratchet and Clank's trophies on Vita?
Yeah, I couldn't play the Vita version at around 30 frames a second, and it was so horrible to fucking control.
Wow.
Yeah.
All right, Bloodborne, 3%. Let's take a look at what trophies. Oh, 4%. Let's take a look at what trophies Keith has gotten in Bloodborne.
Wow, you need 3 more trophies than you have Drake's Fortune platinumed.
No, I have Drake's Fortune platinumed anyway. I have every Uncharted game platinumed.
What are the 3 trophies you don't have then?
DLC, I suppose.
Oh yeah, DLC trophy pack 1.
Assassin's Creed Revelations, 100% done, platinumed. Nice going.
I see you loved Far Cry Primal.
Oh.
Dang, gives me bad feelings. I don't know. I never got into it. It's just, I'm sure I would have liked it if I actually played it, but...
Dragon Ball Xenoverse 2, 100% Platinum. Oh, we'll get into that later. Bitch. We'll get into that later. The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt, 42%. It's going to stay there for a little while.
I got to Platinum that eventually. That deserves a Platinum.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Really?
Yeah, it's a big undertaking, but I can do it. No online trophy, so not into blues.
Uncharted 2, Platinum. Fallout 4, 23%. You got a long way to go if you do.
I never planned that.
Assassin's Creed Unity, 22%. Equally a long way to go if you ever did. Battlefield 4 trophies at 12. We know why. Assassin's Creed Syndicate, platinumed. Way to go.
Thank you.
Infamous First Light. You've actually platinumed Infamous First Light. I did not think you did. Okay, so you platinumed it. Good. Legend of K. That's an interesting one. Me and Keith. Keith called me one day and was like, dude, I found this fucking platformer. Dude, it's like Jack. It's got fucking animations and shit and everything. And we go and play, and you play as a fucking cat thing. And you just run around, and you're basically stuck on the ground constantly with these really cringy fucking controls and this horrible fucking story. Ugh.
Wow. It wasn't a bad game. It just was not Jack. We were comparing it to the Ron game.
Yeah, the
it tried to be Jack.
You platinumed into the Nexus.
Hell
you
yeah.
Platinumed into the Nexus in 4 days and 22 hours. I'm sure you weren't even trying.
See how long it took me to platinum the Uncharted remasters.
Oh my god, I think that literally took him like 3 days.
A day for each one, I think.
A day for each one, yeah. All right,
Uncharted
4 Shadow
was a
Mordor.
Week and 2 days. Uncharted Drake's Fortune Remastered was 2 days and 6 hours. Uncharted 3 was 2 days and 3 hours. Uncharted 2 was a day and 2 hours.
Yep, knew it.
Jesus.
Yep. I fucking power through those bastards.
Let's see here. We got Middle Earth Shadow of Mordor. 52%.
Yeah,
that's
I
could
have platinumed that, but I fell off.
It's a shame because it's such an easy platinum. It really is. Zombie. moving on. Saints Row, getting moving on. Ratchet & Clank.
Go back 100%. To Saints Row. Saints Row.
Saints Row, get out of hell. No,
well,
Saints
let me
Row,
just talk about Saints Row 4 for a second. I have like 90% of the trophies in that game, and a cock blocked me because one of the trophies glitched. That was like the most ridiculous trophy in the game. Like collect all the shard things, you know, all the things you have to collect around the city.
Oh, that's when you ain't hero.
When you're what?
And hero is a 4chan way of saying kill yourself.
Oh, that's lovely. But I fuck 4chan. but I collected all the fucking collectible things, and the trophy didn't pop, and it's a known glitch, and I was like, I'm not doing all that again. Fuck you. So that cock.
Okay, so anyway, Saints Row, get out of hell, 11%. Obviously, you didn't like this one as much as Saints Row 4.
No. I loved Homefront.
Oh.
Homefront, oh god, that game.
Ratchet & Clank PS4, 100%. Obviously. Mm-hmm. Uncharted.
Even I got that
one. The Last of Us Remastered on PS4, 7%. You got 7 trophies. That's really decent. Oh, says the one person who fucking loves Grim Fandango so much. One fucking trophy for you.
The thing is, I enjoyed the game. I enjoyed what I tried to do, but
did you even go outside of the office?
Yeah, fuck you.
Moving on.
Okay. Oh, you've got 3 trophies on Life is Tumblr.
What is that name?
It's a joke.
Life.
Move on. Please.
Life is okay, strange. Anyway. It's basically Life is Tumblr.
Okay. Anyway, Ratchet Deadlocked, 100%. Gonna be doing that myself. Uncharted, yeah, obviously. Saints Row 4 reelected, 61%, but that's because of DLCs and stuff. He really got 75%.
Oh, I thought it was higher than that. The game cockblocked me, so fuck that game.
Okay, anyway. Killzone 3, 31%. Resident Evil, Residents, yeah, blah, blah, blah. Skyrim, 22% on PS3, completely understandable. Frame rate issues, loading times, glitches, never-ending loading screens, I understand. Jack 2, 100%. Jack 3, 100%. Dragon Ball Xenoverse on PS3, 15%. I get it. AC Brotherhood, 33% on PS3. I also get it. Mafia 2, 53%. That's higher than I
was. I was going to get the Platinum. I even done it on hard and everything. Then I was just like, I don't like the game that much.
Oh, you decided then that you didn't like the game?
Yeah, after I finished it on hard.
Halfway through. Fucking hell. Oh, yeah, Assassin's Creed Rogue, 32%. That's kind of sad, considering... Yeah,
I never picked up Rogue. Is it worth it?
Yeah, it's better than Unity.
Oh, yeah.
Is it better than Black Flag?
No.
No. No, it's not. It's very limited, but it definitely had the potential to be better than Black Flag, but it came short because of probably budget, and, you know, it came out the same time as fucking Unity, and it's like... You have Unity, which promises so much, and then you have Assassin's Creed Rogue, which is the second selling game in the series.
Looking back on it, the whole transition from the is the PS4 the 8th gen or the 7th gen?
8.
Yeah, the transition from the 7th gen to the 8th gen was so fucking weird compared to like all of the other transitions in gaming history. Like with cross-platform games and like people making one game for the PlayStation 4 and then also making a same game in that series but for the 3. Yeah. Mm. I hope we don't have a repeat of that when we go into a 9th gen.
Do you think it's going to be a 9th gen, or do you think there's going to be upgraded consoles? Technically there is, because Nintendo released the Switch, so that's technically in the 9th gen.
I don't know. Nintendo's always been straddling the line like halfway. Like they're at like 8.5 gen.
Yeah, I guess.
Just keep dishing out like minor and minor PlayStation 4 updates, because you're going to get something that's still completely different from somebody who doesn't have all the updates, that you might as well just call it a PlayStation 5.
Mm.
All right. So let's see here. We got Jack and Daxter the Precursor Legacy.
Never heard of it.
What's that game?
Never heard.
Yeah, I don't know. Sounds Batman good. Arkham City,
6 days.
Batman Arkham Asylum, 50%. I love that. Okay. Shadow Warrior, 51%.
If you have not played Shadow Warrior, download it right now and fucking buy it. It is the most criminally underrated game I've played in fucking years.
Here's your favorite.
It got a 66 on Metacritic. That's a crime. That's a fucking crime. That fucking phenomenal, the best shooter, it's a shooter that kept my interest till the end. That never happens with shooters.
Speaking of shooters,
that thing got bad reviews. It annoys
me. We have another one from you that I know you love so much and you've played recently.
What, Tomb Raider Definitive Edition?
Doom.
Doom. Oh, Doom. Don't type me started on Doom. God damn it.
Yeah,
I don't like Doom. Do you want to know why I don't like Doom? Shadow Warrior. That's why I don't like Doom. I played Shadow Warrior first. So, and I was like, this game got 90s. This game got like a fucking 90 or something, or an 88 or whatever it was on Metacritic. And Shadow Warrior got a 66. Are you fucking high? Shadow Warrior is clearly the better game.
When are you going to get your last 6 trophies in Dust and an Elysian Tale?
I'm going to get it because I love that game to death. I fucking love it. Oh. And I really need to get it. Yes.
Whenever I
renew my PS Plus, that's fine.
Here's an interesting one. Horizon Zero Dawn, 100%. Keith says it's a 10 out of 10, but fucking hates it.
I don't know how to explain. It's just, yeah,
there's
I've explained
a lot of mixed emotions there.
Phenomenal game, like absolutely fantastic game, technical masterpiece. That's why I platinumed it, just to show that I thank you for making an amazing game, but I don't like it.
Alright, let's see what we got here. Assassin's Creed 4 Black Flag, let's take a look. The main game, you got about 58%. That is definitely, you have played that game to get that. You have played that game.
What game is this?
Black Flag.
Oh yeah, sure.
You've played enough of it to really grasp. Maybe not did a lot of the side stuff, but
I would literally platinum that if it didn't have online trophies. I loved that.
I would too. I loved it too. I almost made it to it myself. L.A. Noir, obviously.
L.A. Noir.
Noir sockpot.
I don't know how to fucking pronounce that shit, but that's what I'm gonna call it. Noir. Wow, that sounds even worse. Anyway. Rocket League, you platinumed that by mistake.
I platinumed that by accident.
How do you platinum something by accident?
I was just playing it and it was like, I go, ding, platinum trophy popped, and I'm like, what the fuck? But even though I have a platinum trophy, I only have 50% of the trophies, so work that out.
You know, you're 19 platinums away from WWE 2013.
Ugh, yeah, fuck that game.
Alright, Sleeping Dogs Definitive Edition, platinum.
Yep.
I want it every time the fucking Steam sales come up. That game's always $5, and I always want to get it, but I never do.
I did. Beat you to it. Let's see. What do we got here? Evil Within 11%. Understandable. You have played that game. No, it doesn't. Rezogun 29%.
I was going to platinum that, but it was ridiculous, so I left it.
We got.
You played long enough into Kane and Lynch 2 to get 14 trophies?
I finished Kane and Lynch 2 because it's like 2 hours long.
How do they have 61 trophies in two? That's like a trophy a minute.
Oh, it has a lot of online trophies, I think.
Oh, okay.
All right, so let's. A lot of uninteresting shit here. Let's find something cool.
Bioshock 2, you obviously loved an entire 2 trophies.
Hasn't able to experience the true Mortal Kombat PS3 45.
I would platinum that, but the platinum of that is
it's
the
Mortal Kombat
of all time.
It's Mortal Kombat.
You have to win like 50 matches in a row online.
Oh god. Knack is at 45%.
Yeah, I was going to platinum that, but the game was a bastard, so I didn't.
Right. The Last of Us PS3, you're at 29%.
I'm going to platinum that, but online trophy said fuck off.
Right.
I don't WWE know how
to 13. PS3.
You did it on Grounded?
Not Grounded, the one before that, because Grounded wasn't on PS3.
Oh, yeah, I did. Oh, yeah, I remember doing that. It was hell. Mainly because you didn't get to see the button prompts.
Yeah.
Infamous 2. 100%.
Yep. Favorite Infamous. Yep. By far.
Really? Sly 2.
2? Oh, yeah, definitely. I think 2's by far the best.
Ratchet and Clank Full Frontal Assault. Even though you say it's the worst one in this series, you have quite a substantial...
You died, Nick.
Oh. You played Ratchet and Clank Full Frontal Assault and actually have quite the substantial amount of trophies for it.
I tried to love it, and I only like it.
you played Red Faction Guerrilla, but you only got 10 trophies?
Good game, but I think I rented it or something. That's why.
Oh, okay.
Here's a funny one. Harry Potter. Or laugh. Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows Part 2. And wait till you hear the percentage on this. Fucking 51%, dude.
What's his rank?
How?
Oh my God.
Why?
I finished the game.
And you got that many trophies?
Yeah. The game's like 2 hours long, firstly, and then the rest of the trophies are just stupid mini games with the Move controller that I didn't have.
How much would I have to pay you to platinum Homefront?
My life. You'd have to pay me my own soul. Because that is the most generic shooter I've ever played in my life.
What about Homefront the Revolution?
Fuck off with that shit.
The Godfather 2. Oh, The Godfather 2.
I rented that. Don't hold me to that.
7%. That game deserves far more.
I would platinum it, though. I don't think I liked it when I rented it. That's why I didn't play it much.
It's a good game.
It was a long time ago. I don't remember.
Well, you probably wouldn't like it either, though, because it does have, like, a character creator. One of the best I've ever fucking seen, honestly.
I liked it in Saints Row.
Well, yeah, the thing about this one is you could, Godfather, what I remember of it, is you can customize your character at any point in time in the game, and it costs nothing, from the menu. Yeah, it was really, so you could basically make your character age throughout the game if you wanted to, which I did every time. Anyway, moving on. WWE SmackDown vs. Raw 2011, 45%. Must have been pretty good.
I just play all wrestling games all year, so that's why so many trophies in them. I'm never going to platinum any of them because of online trophies, but if there wasn't online trophies, I would.
Rocksmith, 3%. No wonder why you wrote Horseburg. No wonder. Anyway.
I reviewed Tekken. That game in Insane Remnants of Epic Proportions, if anyone wants to see my thoughts on it.
Now, Keith, if you got a platinum for every anime you binge-watched, how many platinums would you have?
Like, fucking 2?
About 9.5.
Oh, okay. What about for every anime that you've liked?
How about every anime that you've ever fapped to?
God damn it. Okay, yeah, fap to, that's going to be a larger number.
2.
But for real, how does it feel being 519 in Ireland?
We've established this. It feels good, man. I want to get to 500. I want to get it to the top 500. So I'm never going to stop.
Nick, do you have you've got Keith's trophy numbers handy?
Yeah, let me just back out. What do you need? Just the full amount?
I'll read off what number 500 in Ireland has, starting with bronze, and you'll say what Keith has. So, number 500 has 2,152 bronze.
Ooh. 2,859 for Keith.
Ooh, he's got 836 silvers.
696. He's fucking coming close.
Ooh, 209 golds.
Oh, God.
195 golds.
And 51 platinums.
39 platinums. Keith is catching up.
Ooh, you know, strangely enough, number 940. Only has 2 platinums.
Number what?
Number 949 in Ireland only has 2 platinums. That weirds me out.
What's his trophy level?
Almost 21.
Yeah, it's because he just plays a fuckload of games.
Yeah, Shield Jaguar. But Dalton, capital D, alt O. Capital N. Keith is coming for you. He's gonna take that 500 spot from you in Ireland.
I'm gonna cut a promo on him wrestling style. Hey there, Mr. BD underscore D. I'm coming for you, and I'm taking your 500 title right from your hands.
Now, when are you gonna get number 10?
Probably never. 90 years.
You need a 42 trophy level.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to like get an archived version of the PS4 servers just in order to do it in the time that I need.
Fair enough. All right. Funnily enough, the number.
Oh, thanks.
Funnily enough, the number one guy in Ireland, his name is One Is Never Enough.
Oh,
that's
coincidental. That's fitting for a man with 376 platinums. He's platinumed 95% of the games he owns. Jesus Christ.
Wow. Well, that's that segment done, I guess. That was enjoyable.
We haven't gone over Nick's.
You fucking idiot.
Oh my God, Nick, you literally got away with it.
You bastards!
Oh. Well, Nick's is not special anyway. He's just a boring American.
Yeah. Totally.
Fuck, I think I need to sync my trophies for Nick, because it says he doesn't have Ratchet 2 Platinum, and I'm pretty sure Nick, he does.
Nick, how the fuck do you spell your name?
It's like, clickety clack. I love the...
S-O-U-Z-A.
Wait, so say that again. I mean, what?
Which one do you want? Gamertag or Gamertag?
Not your actual name, obviously, your PSN.
K-L-I-K-K-E-T-Y-K-L-A-C-K.
Oh my God. Okay, found it. Right, clickety clack. You have. Your trophy level is 15 with your stupid Jack 1 avatar. You're a cannabis advocate. LO. That's all PSN team says about you. You have 2,055 silver. 13. Well, why is silver first?
I have 2,055
trophies altogether. You have 2,000 trophies altogether. 13 platinum's not bad. 82 gold, 424 silver, and 1,536 bronze.
He's number 73,448 in the United States. Down 193 since last week, and number 233,000 in the world.
Well done, Nick. The latest game you've played, Ratchet and Clank: A Crack in Time, 85%, 33 out of 37 trophies. You're fucking close, man.
Very close.
Rage, 9% trophies, 8 of 61. How's that game?
Rage is all right. It's a game that you'll never be able to platinum, but it's a good time.
Okay. Ratchet and Clank 3, up your arse. You have 100% platinum. Well done, good friend. Ratchet and Clank 2.
It took you the same exact amount of time for Ratchet and Clank 3 and 2 to platinum. Both 2 months and 3 weeks.
Oh, wow. Correct.
Really?
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
And then Ratchet and Clank 1, platinumed.
A month and three weeks. Oh, so a month quicker.
Well done, Nick. Well done.
Galaxy, the Interdimensional, there's only 11 trophies in that game, man. I'm sure you can get, like, the other 10.
Dude, that game was fucking trash.
Sleeping Dogs Definitive Edition, 14%. Why, Nick? Why?
Because I lost my interest in it like I did when I fucking played it on the original PS3.
You can't. Tomb Raider Definitive Edition, 0 trophies.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I played it for an hour and I was like, this is really fucking good. And then I never played it again.
But Bloodborne, the game, your favorite game of all time, has you have 12%.
Ooh, you died a lot. Resi 4, you've got 1 out of 12 trophies.
Come on. Like, Resi 4 is awesome. You don't like Resident Evil 4? What's wrong with you, you alien?
I didn't care for it.
How?
You can deal with the controls.
Yeah, that's it.
No, I couldn't. It was too damn fucking claustrophobic. It was worse than fucking The Evil Within, and I like The Evil Within for that.
Yeah, it's the same makers, so you're a nerd. Anyway, Metal Gear Rising. Metal Gear Rising Revengeance, great game, I hear. 20%.
Yeah, oh yeah. For 20%, there's a lot with that.
Assassin's Creed Revelations, 70%. So what close. What happened, Nick? What happened?
I got bored of it. Wanted to move on to other things.
Dragon Ball Rage and Blast, 28%. You call yourself a Dragon Ball fan.
I think I've got more trophies than that. Fuck.
I was going to go for it. I was really going to go for it, but then I fought this Japanese guy on this online match.
Who has their phone on?
Not me.
It's my fucking phone, and there's literally nothing I could do about it.
Go on.
I was playing Raging Blast, and I fought this Japanese guy, and he had, like, this fucking rig set up to where he had, like, his upgrade board. You know what I'm talking about, Jack? That thing?
Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
Yeah, he had that thing set up in such a fucking way that I literally had to play as Super Saiyan 2 Gohan and fucking Kid Buu, because you know their combos.
Complete spam.
Yeah, I had to. I had to complete spam fucking use that fucking rolling ball thing that Boo does, that Kid Boo does.
I
people who do it against me, but I love doing it to other people.
Oh yeah, definitely.
Nick, do you hear something interesting?
Yeah, what?
What do you think your first ever trophy was?
My first ever trophy?
Mm-hmm.
I'm almost certain. I'm almost certain that it was the first Jack and Daxter one. The first game.
Ever trophy.
Yeah.
According to these profiles, your first ever trophy was Unbound from Skyrim 3 years ago.
Only three?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I've accumulated this much from 3 years of hard labor.
And top of the heap, Jack and Daxter, Precursor Legacy, was your first platinum from 3 years ago, so congratulations.
Yeah, thanks.
Your 500th trophy was Assassin's Creed Liberation HD, complete in sequence one. Will you fucking turn off notifications on your phone? My ears are dying.
Yeah, I would if I knew how to fucking do that.
Americans. I can't work with
Minecraft story mode. 4 trophies.
Yeah, horseshit. Absolute fucking horseshit.
Great. Dragon Ball Xenoverse. 41 out of 50 trophies. I'm very proud of you.
Yeah, 98%. He was cockblocked like a big.
I need Krillin's milk. I need to do some more training sessions
Speaking of milk. Speaking of milk, you deserve not getting that milk because you got enough milk. My name is fucking Mayo, you stupid fucking sellout.
Hey, it was free.
Do they have Shower with Your Dad Simulator on
not yet.
PS4? They really need to not get yet. It on there. I'd love to platinum that game.
They need to fucking. They just need to purge the PS Store, in my opinion. Just start all over, like fucking hell. Amount of shit on that thing. Warframe 6%. Witcher 3 Wild Hunt 37. Not bad. You're catching up with me.
Took you 5 hours to platinum Ratchet and Clank PS4.
Oh.
Yeah, that's normal, yeah.
Took me how long?
5 days.
Ha ha, I beat you, bastard.
Well, yeah, I was only trying for like the last three.
Oh, well, the reason why it took me 5 days is because Keith lended me his account, and I was like really pressed for time, and I was like, yeah, I'm going to fucking do this as fast as I possibly can.
Jack 2 and Jack 3 took the exact same amount of time for you to platinum, 1 year and 1 month.
Wow.
That's because I platinum both of them on the same day.
Dude, when I platinum Jack 2 and 3, like my first trophy I got for those games was in like 2012 or something. It's going to be like 5 years to platinum this game.
Middle-earth Shadow of Mordor Game of the Year Edition. Platinum. Well done. Well done, Nick.
Yep.
Fallout 4. Platinum. Well done, Nick. Well done. That's a hard. That's not a hard platinum, but it's an annoying platinum.
It's an annoying platinum, yeah.
Yeah. Amazing Spider-Man 2 Platinum, 64%.
Yeah, good game. Good game. Just got really bored of it and didn't really think it deserved to be platinumed on my list. That's all.
Uncharted Drake's Fortune, 18%. You don't like Uncharted?
Not really.
Yeah, no. Uncharted,
technically, but I don't really care for them that well. I think I like The Last of Us more.
Yeah, I feel the same way. Like, I feel like Uncharted is just, I don't know, I feel like I'd rather watch an Indiana Jones.
Same fucking game 4 times over.
Yeah, and like, the combat's not that good until you get to, like, 3, and even 2, like, the combat's decent, but it's not even the majority of the thing, and the climbing is all the same. Like, there's no way to fail the climbing unless you're sporadically hitting the fucking circle button.
Or the fucking camera decides to put you in an awkward angle, like it does all the time.
Yeah.
All the time. Yeah. Especially in the first game. First game especially.
It's a decent game to just chill out and, like, play.
It's a joy the first time around, but I would never
play.
Leave my favorite PS3 games alone.
Are those your favorite PS3 games?
Yeah, they were, but I don't think they are anymore. I think my opinions have changed, but yeah, I still love Uncharted. I really do love them.
Yeah, one thing about Naughty Dog is, you know, they don't come out with a whole lot of things that are completely new and innovative, but they're really good at taking already existing genres and refining them. Yeah. Like Jack and Daxter is a great example of that. And
they out GTA to GTA.
I don't think they out GTA. I don't.
They made a better open world than GTA, in my opinion.
I think Jack 2's open world, there was nothing to do. It was needlessly windy and large.
Yeah, and compare that with GTA 3. What can you do in GTA 3?
It's the exact same thing. I've never played GTA 3, so.
You go around and you run over people. It's the exact GTA 3 better than GTA 3 done it.
They completely
copied GTA 3, but they've done it so much better, so they're allowed to do that.
I can't give GTA 3 any credit because I played it like a few months ago. So let's take a minute to analyze Jack and Daxter characters' fingers, right? They all move.
Yes.
They all move, right?
And they're separated. They're fucking separated.
And their eyes blink. Right? As soon as I seen the first fucking thing and it looked like it was rendered in like 360p, it was like, oh. And then like seeing him hold this fucking huge blocky phone with his fucking mitten hand, I was like, oh.
Yeah, those PS2 GTA games had some fugly graphics.
I was playing San Andreas a couple of weeks ago and I sent Nick some screenshots and I think he literally puked.
Oh my god, that fucking... But it also goes to show you that to play a good game can be a good game, and it doesn't need to have spectacular graphics. The game
I downloaded
is great, but it just... I got San Andreas
for PC, and I downloaded like a 4 gigabyte texture pack, and the fucking game, it was mainly a shader pack, TBH, and it makes the game look better, but like there's only, you can only make it look so good.
There's only so much you can do.
I mean, the blood looks really great. I got the best blood texture pack.
I can say the same about the graphics of GTA on PS2. Are as rough as the gameplay on GTA and PS2, right? Now, compare the core gameplay, right? The core gameplay of GTA, compare that to Jack, right? Compare the graphics of GTA, compare that to Jack.
No fucking contest. Right? No fucking contest.
The only thing that really GTA beats it on is story and variety and things to do, like, you know? And that's only in the later Vice City to San Andreas. That's the only thing that beats it on, because open world is the main focus of GTA. Then again, on Jack, the main focus is platform and open world. The main focus is, like, it doesn't really have a focus. That's the thing that's a lot of people's problem with it. But that's what I love about it. It gives you so much fucking... The focus is on the mechanics. Every mechanic they do, they implement
the problem,
so well.
And I love the Jack and Daxter series for that, too. But the problem that they run into is that when they throw 20 darts at a wall hoping something's going to stick, they rarely go back.
The thing about that is every dart control
so you have
hits.
One flight minigame. You have one, you know, hang glider minigame. You have one, whack-a-mole minigame. You have one Pac-Man minigame.
It's a platformer. What platformer does not have throwaway minigames? What platformer? Can you name one platformer that doesn't have a rail shooter in it?
That doesn't mean that rail shooters are good in platformers.
I'm just saying, it's a platformer, so it's like a staple that has to have these random minigames in there.
Dad! Shut the
I'm enjoying this. Shut up, Nick.
Will you fucking finish so we can move on? This segment is so damn long.
Jack and Daxter's better than GTA there. That's what I'm saying.
There we go. Okay, there we go. Let's continue. Fantastic. We all agree.
Okay. Fallout 3, 10%. Holy shit, Nick.
Only 10%.
Yeah. Assassin's Creed 3, 57%.
Yeah. Yeah, when that game comes out on PS4, I will be platinuming it.
Black Flag, 85%.
Click into that. See the actual fucking... Right. Actually, look at what I'm missing.
91%. 91%, right? And you are missing... Sharing is caring. Share each type of discovery with friends once. Oh my god. Oh god. Siren Song. Rescue pirate hostages by distracting enemies with dancers so you can get
that's
that.
Easy. That's easy.
Yeah. Committed to the cars, reach level 55 and good luck. Lab technician playing complete a game session of game lab and multiplayer public playlist. You could do that if the servers were up.
Yeah.
All rounder, play on every game mode, and the only real one that is gonna stop you here is the level 55 one.
Yeah. And honestly, yeah. I'm already like level 25.
Yeah, the server's still up though. If the servers are still up, I tell you to go get that now before they fucking go down.
Yeah. Anyway, yeah, so I basically have that one in the bag if I could just get those online trophies basically.
Mm. Alright, AC2, 91%. That's on PS3. You've platinumed that on PS4.
Yep.
And Jack and Daxter 100%, of course. So yeah, that's your trophies.
Nice. Ooh, Keith, you should get attacking...
Go on.
You should get attacking Zegita 2, because literally nobody has platinumed it.
Does it have a platinum?
Yes, it has a platinum, but nobody has gotten it.
Is it Japanese?
And only 53 people.
Yeah.
Okay. Warhammer 40K Death Watch. Okay. Only 10 people on that.
You gotta keep in mind here, a lot of the things that people haven't platinumed are impossible to platinum.
Yeah.
Glitch trophies that you just can't get.
You've got a point.
Keith, what's the next segment? I need to get prepared.
The next segment, Nick. You've gotta get prepared. What?
I gotta prepare my anus.
Okay, so the next segment, folks, I hope you enjoyed that segment. It did drag on a bit, but I think we had some interesting conversations.
Yeah.
But the next segment, Nick, are you ready for this? Is your anus ready?
My anus is prolapsed and ready.
This is a new segment I'm introducing right now. Are you ready? Do you want to get the drum roll going? This is a segment I would like to call Dad Joke of the Week.
And my suffering.
Are you ready? Are you ready for today's dad joke, my friends?
Yes, I am.
Yes, I am.
This dad joke comes from my own brain because I didn't conceive this segment until earlier this morning. And the joke is something my father tells me every few weeks, and I want to punch him every time he tells me it. Okay, are you prepared to hear this amazingness, my friends?
Yes, I am. Yes. Ready, Keith. Ready,
here
friend.
We go. I gotta get into this character. This is nice and short and sweet. It's two sentences. Okay, lads, I have a question for yous.
Alright.
Did you hear about the carrot that died?
That was...
That's not the joke. That's not the joke, you idiot. You
answered that was two sentences. You gave yourself two sentences.
No, that was one sentence.
Okay.
Hey, lads.
Did you hear about the carrot that died? Have any of you heard about the carrot that died?
No.
Oh, that's a shame. There was a big turnip at his funeral.
Every day we stray further from God's light.
Get it? Turnip? As in turnip?
Yeah, Irish fuck, I get it. God damn
it. And that's the dad joke of the week. Please send all that
keith@vobox.com. Now, joke that will make you want to flag this video of the week. Are you ready for this one?
Okay, here's a racist joke of the week, I presume.
No, it's not racist. It's well, worse than that.
Always right.
Oh, great. Do I have to edit this out? Answer me this right now.
What?
Will I have to edit this out? Like, is it bad enough to that I would have to be forced to edit it out?
I don't think you will.
Okay.
How do you know your girlfriend's too young?
How?
We're going to a
when you need place. To when you need to spoon feed her your dick by making airplane noises.
That's good. That's not too bad. I don't need to edit that out. Okay. That's more tame.
I had a 9/11 joke, but I decided
too
against
soon.
It.
Too soon. It's been 20 years.
It's been 16.
Yeah, 4 years. It's 20th anniversary, and then there's gonna be a big deal about then. And you know, even say that if we're still doing this podcast on the 20th anniversary of 9/11, say that joke.
Let's go.
Okay, so that's the joke segment. That's great, wasn't it? Right then. This is a real video game heavy show, but who cares? Because video games are cool. Topic of the show. Are you ready, my peeps?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. Ready.
Topic of the show is our most triumphant video game moments.
Who wants to go first?
I think mine is really obvious, so maybe I should get it over with.
All right.
My most triumphant video game moment was finishing the Jack Tree gun course with no guns. The second one. I recorded my feelings on video. When I done this,
I'm gonna be honest. I still haven't watched that yet.
You should. I could barely talk. I mean, even more than usually. And it the feeling I got when I done. I wasn't even recording. Like I was. I recorded. I wasn't recording myself. I was recording. I recorded the gameplay for every day for about 2 fucking months. Like every time I turned on Jack Tree Detritus. And I was just recording. I was just sitting there in a zombified state, just pressing fucking square and all. Square no. And then I heard a door open. I looked up, I was like, oh, I failed. I looked up and I had the number. I remembered the number. 9,036 or something like that. And it was like, oh, it's like the gods just shone down heaven.
Did you do like a Rocky montage of like all your failures, like put it like 20 times speed?
I was going to do it by delete. I need the amount of times I had to do this. I had to delete all the fucking footage because it just clogged up my hard drive.
Mm-hmm.
But the minute I done it, I fucking hopped up, like done a little fucking flip up, ran, grabbed my camera, and started screaming, I done it! And then my mother was screaming from my bedroom, will you shut the fuck up? And that it was a nice moment, and it felt so good, and that was my most fulfilling video game moment.
That's very wholesome, Keith.
Thank you. I felt very nutritional after it. the right word, I swear.
What about you, Nick? Or do you want me to go?
I guess I'll go, yeah. One thing, I think my best video game moment hasn't come yet. Because the minute I fucking get that fucking Krillin's milk fucking trophy, I'm going to flip my shit. And I know it. But that's not my fault. It's not from my lack of talent. It's from lack of luck and RNG. But if I had to give one for right now...
It is for your lack of talent, Nick. I done it. And you know how I done it. I grinded and grinded and grinded. It's what you have to do.
It should not be that way. It should not be that way.
Well, it is that way. That's life.
Well, it shouldn't be that way.
So go up and do it.
No. I won't. I'll be a fucking defiant 12-year-old. Okay, I would say my most defining moment right now, just out of spite of you, Keith, is hearing it takes place in Assassin's Creed Revelations.
No.
Right.
Oh yeah.
Right. I endured listening to Keith, giving him moral support, right? Doing this stupid fucking compulsory DLC called The Lost Archive. Now, folks, nightmares.
This is like shitty first-person ones.
Yeah, yes. it's a sack of shit. It's a interesting story, but completely overshadowed by unyielding rage and just
stupid gameplay. 30 frames per second, first-person shit gameplay that does not responsive.
Oh, it was bad. It was bad, right? So Keith is sitting here now. This is an actual quote. Fuck! About every 3 seconds, and then a lot
of you before, like 5 times the level.
Fucking damn it! Why I fell true to fucking like a lot of that, right?
Do you want to explain what this trophy is?
There's two trophies that one of them is for called Impress Warren Vidic. I remember it well.
This is a hard one.
It's just a lot of basically extremely mediocre first-person platforming. Building blocks is dodging laser beams and other devices of certain death. And you have to get through the whole level without dying. And it is quite a challenge because I think it takes approximately like 10 minutes to get through it, like if you don't know what you're doing.
Have you guys played Fallout 4 Far Harbor?
Nope. Don't care right now. We're talking about fucking my...
No, this relates back to it, because I just remembered, like, thinking back to, like, the first-person minigame in Assassin's Creed Revelations, it's a lot like the first-person minigame in Far Harbor.
Was Far Harbor actually good?
Well, the DLC in general was about as good as Fallout 4 gets, but the minigame, thinking about it, it's like... Yeah, it's this first person thing where you've got like building blocks and things like that, and it's like, oh fuck. They were like, oh yeah, Assassin's Creed Revelations did this, maybe we should try it.
Everyone loved that. Everyone loved Revelations.
Yeah, so anyway. So Keith finally did it and he felt so proud of himself. So proud of him. He was like, if I wasn't mistaken, I would consider that one of his biggest fucking triumphs ever, was getting through that. Because that took, like, I think that took you like 3 days of nonstop torture to get through that. And I was daunting it at the time. Like, I was like, oh no. Like, as I hear it and shit. And there's another one for crossing the sticks, and that one's a fucking cakewalk. It's easier, but anyway, so here I go playing. Here I go playing it. I start, and Keith, I initiate share play, you know, because he's like, I want to watch you suffer, you know, because I was like joking and shit, right? First, I start like basically, if I could describe how I went through this, I would say skipping and like tossing a yo-yo on the ground. And like I started doing it and shit, and he was like, how did you do that? He was like, and here comes the next part. How are you gonna do this, huh? And he's like laughing like Vegeta, like, and then I go through and he's like, huh, what? And then I get to the next part and I keep doing it and shit, right?
And eventually I get about 90% through and I actually fail. And he was like, you just went 90% through it without. And then a few other times I try it and we're still talking and stuff. And I'm like, oh yeah, by the way, Keith, like we talked for like 5 minutes after I finished it. And I was like, by the way, I didn't. He was like, what, when? I was like, oh, about 5 minutes ago.
And then the next in my defense, I had it much harder because my game was a physical version, which is glitched the fuck. And I kept falling through the blocks. And
it made
life much harder.
Once. Yes. Yeah, I fell through the floor a few times. But not anywhere near what you did. But then the second part, I did that in about 3 hours. The second part of constantly, because the I think the most infuriating thing about that, about the Lost Archive, is the slow walk. Mm-hmm. The slow walk is really bad, and especially the second one, which is easier but still very monotonous. You have to walk a distance.
The thing that got me is that there's a delay in it. It's fine for Assassin's Creed, like it's fine for a third person game, but if you have a first person view and there's a delay, that's just fucked. And it runs at 30 frames a second, so it feels unresponsive as it is. And it's fucking just shit.
Yeah, we're just not going back there.
Sounds like it was pretty bad.
Vietnam.
It was his bad, but it felt really good because I did it in like so quickly, and then Keith was like, "Yeah, you're in the home stretch now," and I was like, ha, 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 ha. "Yeah, I felt really, really good about that." But yeah, Jack. So speaking of orgasms, let's talk about you.
Did I miss something? Did I fall asleep when you were talking about orgasms or something?
No. Let's.
No, your virgin ears just blocked it out.
Oh, okay. I see.
Now, my most rewarding memories in gaming. Well, if we're gonna talk about when I was a kid, the fucking puzzle, the whack-a-mole thing on Jack 2. I literally completed Jack 3 before I completed that fucking puzzle. Me and my brother, and we even got my dad in there occasionally. We went at that fucking thing so many times. It was like we were like running up against a wall expecting it to like fall over. And then one day it was either me or my brother, somebody, I think it was me, tried it out of the blue, like, oh, this fucking thing, you know, maybe this time. And then like it worked and I was like, oh shit. And then, you know, I beat Jack 2 after already beating Jack 3. But, you know, I was like, I was not even 10 years old, so.
It's funny how everyone in your family found that hard. Like, even the grown-ups found that hard. Right. When I play that today, I'm like, I can do that, like, really easily.
You played the game about 17 times, so.
Well, true. True. I guess.
Yeah, my most recent playthrough of Jack 2, well, I almost completed the whack-a-mole one.
The one where in Cruise Place where you have to get the artifact out of the machine.
Why was that so hard?
Yeah. Are you fucking kidding me?
Dude, it's literally on the screen, the shape of your controller. You don't even have to look. Like, if you hold the controller, it just press the buttons where the shit pops up. Like, I don't understand.
The Harvey family, it runs in the Harvey family. Like, dyspraxia is a big thing in the family.
Wow. But no, they fucking trick fuck you on that stuff, man. And you try to go for the golds, but then you end up missing like ones, and then the electric ones pop up and it's like,
how do you miss?
It's like, ah,
goes up on X, you fucking hit X.
I don't want to talk about it.
But he's done it, and he's very triumphant about it, and that's all that matters. Isn't that
and,
right, Jack?
And that was when that's my best memory before I was 10.
Oh, what happened after you were 10?
After it's probably that time when I got the rope in Red Dead Redemption and I finally fulfilled my darkest fantasy. No, I'm playing. shit. I don't. Current gaming? I don't know. I've had a lot of. I really love, like, when things just go perfectly in games like The Last of Us, where, like, you get, like, three, like, headshots with the bow in a row or. The most recent thing that comes to my mind, because I, you know, over the last year I haven't played a lot of video games because I'd been doing a lot of other stuff with my life, I was playing through The Last of Us on PS4, and when you're in the last sort of section with the fireflies, spoiler alert, with the fireflies, I you know, like, they're all, like, standing in front of you, like, a wall of fire, essentially. And I threw a smoke bomb, which disoriented them. And then I threw a nail bomb into that. And one of the guys, like, he, like, got knocked back, and I just opened up on him. And the other guys didn't do anything, so I flanked around them, threw a Molotov, and they were finished off. And I was like, wow, that was fucking smooth.
Mm. Nice, nice.
Well, so that is the, what are we running at? How far
are we at? 1 hour 35 minutes, and we have 3 more segments left. Ooh. All right. So the next segment is our first impressions of recently announced games or games that are not out yet. Would be more accurate. Destiny 2. Anyone seen it? Because I haven't, and I could care less. So I'm not
gonna Okay. So Destiny. I guess I'm the one talking about this. Fuck. It's actually come out yet.
If only one person is going to talk about it, maybe we shouldn't talk about it.
No. Let's get this out. Let's get this out. It's topical. it was a little gameplay, not a gameplay trailer. It was a little CG trailer with this fucking hunter. You remember the Hunter's Jack, like that one subclass? Yeah. You played as a hunter and. It showed this hunter there, and he was sitting there drinking, and I was like, you're a fucking robot. How the fuck can you drink? Whatever. Probably fueling or something, refueling. And he's sitting there talking, and he's getting his story all fucked up and shit. He's, like, talking over himself and shit. He's kind of like a charismatic character, you know? Like a cool robot, you know? Like, he should have, like, the fucking silk fire shirt on, plays RuneScape, has the fucking sunglasses, you know, the whole deal. And... it's basically just shows him, like, walking off, like, look at how great this game is going to be, you know, but all I could think about is it's going to be another fucking game where you're going to have a whole bunch of fucking paywalls and shit, and you're not going to be able to reach maximum level because you're not going to have the DLCs to get to that level. And that was a big flaw with me with that game, because you couldn't do anything. You couldn't even, like, turn the game on and be like, yeah, I'm just going to play some mindless Destiny and just level up and collect shit or get some more cool shit, because you're completely cock-blocked by paywalls.
The game was a grind fest.
It was a fine grind fest. It was a fun grind fest, playing with people and stuff like that. But when you didn't want to buy a fucking DLC, you know, it's like, yeah, you want to have this really cool fucking bone mold fucking armor with feathers and a dragon tail? Well, you better pay $20 to get the fucking Taken Bastard to fucking, yeah, no. Nothing. And then cycling the game's life for 3 years. It was just...
Weren't they planning for the original Destiny to last, like, the entire console generation?
Yes, it was... the only thing I could imagine right now is if you got Destiny on, like, the fucking last year of, like, PlayStation 4, Xbox One... like, you would probably be like, okay, so I'm playing the game. What does it start at? Oh, it's about 44 gigabytes. And then there'd be, like, a patch on it that would run at, like, 72 fucking gigabytes. Like, that's what I was thinking. Like, it was going to be, Jesus. Like, they were going to keep... I thought they were just going to, like, keep making the game bigger and bigger and bigger. And, like, I mean, sure, you got to make your money, you know? You got to have your microtransactions. You got to have your DLCs. But I was expecting them to do something a little more along the lines of, like, Xenoverse 2. Like, give the guy who doesn't have the money a fucking update so that he could still play the game. You know what I mean? And enjoy it, kind of. But no. Everything is under a fucking paywall and shit. And it's just... And I even fucking spent $5 on Destiny after getting it to get some stupid fucking randomized fucking package. It was the worst decision of my life.
Yeah, why would you do that?
Destiny was just... I'm not going to knock it. Destiny earns itself... a 5 out of 5. I know we're not really rating games, but it gets a 5 because it does have really good gameplay mechanics. It's a
5 out of 5.
I meant 5 out of 10. 5 out of 10. Sorry, not 5 out of 5.
That's a bit high.
Are you fucking kidding me? No.
So it's a completely average game. In the end,
it's a completely average game. It has really good gameplay ideas. It's a first-person shooter. You know. It's a first-person shooter. You know, it's got some good gameplay. Mechanics to it, nothing else. It, like, every other aspect of it, because of the paywall and the story is so fucking mediocre, and it just feels like, why am I doing this? It feels like a beta. Just, it's like, it's an idea that didn't get to fucking spread its wings. You know?
Yeah.
So.
Yep. I get you. But Destiny 2, do you think they're going to fix any of this shit?
I sure shit hope Bungie does. Or whoever the fuck develops it. I hope they do. Because if it's the same thing, and it's just like, yeah, you get some of the stuff from the last game, you know, like some of that stuff. You know, but then we're going to have these new DLCs here. What I want Destiny to do, and it's never going to do it, is make a fucking single-player campaign.
Just make
a single campaign and just make it to where you don't have to be online all the fucking time to play it. I mean, I have Destiny sitting on my shelf right now. I would love to put that thing in and toil around with it for a little while. I mean, I even got 25% on the trophies. Like, I played it. And I see it sitting there, and it's just like fucking lost potential. Yeah. Like, it could have done so much better. It's like, honestly, the gameplay style, it's like, yeah, Mass Effect. This is what Mass Effect wish it was. Like, gameplay-wise, it's just, I mean, the graphics are good too, but I mean, everything else is just, it's like, why am I doing this? I could be playing Jack Daxter or Assassin's Creed or like anything else, really.
Bad boy.
I could be playing My Name is Mayo. It's literally that bad. At least My Name is Mayo has a fucking finish. This game does not. If you don't buy anything. Yeah.
I get you. Well, hopefully with Destiny 2, they rectify their mistakes. And by the trailer you described, it looks like they're going for a story this time. So that's interesting.
Yeah, I guess. But then again, I don't know anything about the story because I didn't pay $40. You know, yeah. I don't know anything. I mean, there could have been a story. There could have been a hell of a story. From what I've heard, there is a hell of a story to it, but it's not really canon. I'm not going to pay for that type of story expansion. If it didn't matter, sure. I guess I would pay for it if I absolutely wanted it. I can buy the shit, you know? And it just seems more or less that the character that they brought in is more of a mascot.
Yeah.
It gives you the mascot feeling from the trailer.
I get you.
All right, let's move on.
That's Destiny 2. Hopefully they fix the shit. And hopefully it's a good game. Shadow of War. I'll start with this one because Nick's been talking for a while. Jack, have you seen what Shadow of War?
I have no idea what Shadow of War is.
It's Shadow of Mordor 2. Awful name, I know. Absolutely awful name, but...
It's a horrible name.
It is. Shadow of War.
It's compensating for something. It's going to be compensating.
Yeah. But it looks like Shadow of Mordor 2. Not much really to say. It's Shadow of Mordor number 2. There's more things to do. Run around. You can go to more than Mordor now. And that's why, yeah.
I guess the
Nick,
best
you're more of a Shadow of Mordor guy. You don't, you
I've platinum again. Twice. Platinum Shadow of Mordor twice. So, I would say Shadow of War is basically going to be Shadow of Mordor, or what it should have been. Like, you go and look at Shadow of Mordor, it's going to be a beta. It's going to look like a beta, feel like a beta.
The thing with Shadow of Mordor for me is that was my problem with it. It just felt so boring. Like, I could never resonate with it because I'm a big Lord of the Rings fan as well, which is weird. But I just could not. I hate it. I'm going to say I hated the story. I thought it was so fucking boring. I hated the atmosphere. Everything was just brown, and then when there was green, it was just green, and it was like it just felt so empty. And then there was a random orc here that would attack you, and then I'd attack the one, and then I'd be like, I'm bored. I played enough to finish it, and I did enjoy it, but overall, it just felt like baited to me, as you said.
It's kind of along the lines of Destiny. I know that makes me puke saying that, but it's because Shadow of Mordor is definitely a better game than Destiny ever could be. It's not a first person shooter. There you go. Shadow of Mordor was a game that could have been a lot more. When you play it, every time you play it, you're like, okay, they're onto something here. And then it just kind of falls short in a way, and you can't quite put your finger on it. But Shadow of War looks like everything that you had a problem with in the first one is completely rectified. So far, from what I've seen gameplay-wise, like just like combat styles and stuff, there's more relationships with the orcs.
It looks like it's going to be an overall much better project. Technically wise, the graphics aren't—they're not lackluster, but they're definitely no Horizon.
I call this—I call what I'm going through right now, Horizon, the Horizon After Effect. You see, after playing Horizon, every single game looks like shit compared to it, because Horizon is the best looking game ever made, hands down. And looking at gameplay for this, I'm like, this looks like shit. But no, it doesn't look like shit. It's just because it's not Horizon. It doesn't look as polished, as smooth, as fucking... just so...
Horizon is a prodigy child, basically.
Horizon is the best looking game ever made by leaps and bounds. Only thing that comes close to it is Uncharted 4.
What about VR games? Like those really good looking VR games?
yeah, Dual Simulator. but yeah, Shadow of Mordor is gonna come along. It's gonna hit hard, and I think it's gonna do well. And before we know it, we may have a trilogy on our hands.
Mm. Ooh, but maybe.
But when I seen the trailer, I really overreacted to it. I thought I was watching it with you.
He jumped off the fucking top of the thing, and he you could do an attack jump off the top of a fucking tower now.
Yeah.
And Nick stood up and went, ah!
Yeah, like, it was, like, dead quiet early in the morning, right? Like, the sun was not even, like, barely up, and I lost track of time watching it. And Talion jumped off the thing and initiated a bow. And which is, like, initiated, like, shooting a bow and, like, all slow time. And I was just sitting there, and all of a sudden, I was like, yo,
I just put my head in my fucking hands, and I was like, now Nick's fan fucking girl. And I was like, oh no.
It's not that good. That's Nick's waifu.
Well, I mean, it wasn't. To me personally, that is everything I was looking for in Shadow of War. Shadow of Mordor. And me personally, I really enjoyed the gameplay. Out of, like, the whole entire game, I didn't really feel restricted that much. I mean, there's a few things here and there, but, I mean, the game is, like, it's a game that doesn't come around very often. It's a type of game that does not come around. Granted, it's an open world, and open world games are, like, fucking being shit out of, like, fucking gaming industry's fucking rectum every fucking month now. But,
yeah.
I mean, when you get one that's as polished as that and as memorable, even if you didn't like it, Keith, it's a memorable game. It's fucking...
I understand why people love it. I did like it. I didn't not like it. It didn't resonate me. It wasn't like the game of the century, like a lot of people were saying.
Yeah, it's a game that kind of gets you, but not enough. And I understand it, because when I play that game, it's like
doesn't that game use the Arkham Asylum combat style?
They took a lot from Arkham.
Yeah, they kind of made it their own. I personally believe they made it a lot better.
I do too. I agree with that. I think when you play Arkham Asylum, if you go back and play it, it's very unresponsive. Like,
well, the Arkham series.
Yeah. I'm playing Arkham City. It's much more responsive than Arkham City. It's much more improved. In Arkham Asylum,
you take the Arkham game that came out like the year before Mordor, and then you compare those two.
Okay, I've never played that one, so...
Let's say this. This is what Shadow of War is. This is kind of why it's special to me, in a sense. You take the Batman fighting style, right? And instead of making it fists and batarangs and shit like that, you take it and turn it into medieval swordplay, which I am personally a sucker for medieval-themed games, and teleportation powers instead. You take those two elements, and then you add in Assassin's Creed climbing and basically like assassinations and shit like that. You add those two elements together, and then like a slight hint of like hack and slash. By the time, like at the beginning of the game, it's not a hack and slash. It has to be kind of stealthy and shit. But near the end, it's like you basically turn into a fucking monster.
Mm.
So, and it has a lot of elements of... it has a very respectable leveling up system. It doesn't just throw you into the world and like you can do everything you want. And that's one thing that is really killing me about Shadow of War. I swear to Christ, if they do the Ratchet thing, every fucking Ratchet game, what happens?
Lose all your weapons.
You lose everything. It's like, keep hold of your shit, Ratchet. What the fuck? You know?
Well, that presents more challenges for the developers.
Yeah.
Challenge away. I mean, jacked on a two, so no one's perfect.
Yeah, but I mean, don't make it to where, I mean, you learned all those powers. You know?
It made sense for Jack to lose, so that's the thing. It made sense for Jack to lose all his weapons.
Yeah. They made sense in that. And then in Ratchet, they started kind of making sense of that too, especially in Into the Nexus when the ship explodes. But
yeah. 1 to 2 made sense. 2 to 3, oh, yeah. I don't know about that.
He knew he was going into war, and he's like, he didn't bring a single gun.
Yeah.
Oh, and it's cool. And it's just like, oh, remember that dense alloy full body armor? Yeah, let's leave that. Let's just leave that there. Yeah. Oh, and the Rhino too, by the way. Yeah, that can't come with us. We need to put that somewhere, you know. So I'm just really
hoping home in the safe.
How about this? How about if every weapon Ratchet gets in Ratchet 2, what about if those weapons don't work in certain galaxies? What for region locked?
Well, the way that
I guess Warner Brothers got a hold of that.
The way that everything wrong with Ratchet and Clank 3 would describe it as there's some evidence to say that Megacorp weapons are illegal in that galaxy, which is partially why Slim Cognito is the only one who's allowed to sell them.
Yeah, that makes sense, I guess.
Oh, I thought of something really interesting since we're on the little like Ratchet sub segment. I've been playing through Crack in Time, and I've noticed a shitload of interesting plot holes.
Mm-hmm. You ready? Really?
All right, so the first one, right? The first one.
Is this like the most obvious one where you can, you can't go back in time ever to change anything? Oh, here's a ball to make you go back in time. And
no, I've actually explained that.
How?
I figured it out in my head. You know how we said like earlier, we're like, oh, you could just go back in time at will, like at some points, you know? It's like, why? It's simple, because those are unchecked, and Sigmund's simply focusing them. It's not anything. You're not actually taking the clock and taking the handle and pulling it back. It's already there. It's just fuck ups in the time space continuum.
Oh, okay. I never thought of it that way. That actually makes a lot of sense.
Yeah, but anyway, so the big plot hole here is this, right? Well, one of them. It's not really a plot hole. It's more of a. Anyways, it's just weird. When Ratchet is going into Vorsalon's ship, well, not Vorsalon's ship, any like open area, really. Why the fuck doesn't Ratchet have his rebreather on?
What?
Why?
What are you talking about?
His rebreather.
He's breathing in space.
On, yeah. some places, not the nefarious space station.
Inside of it, he wouldn't
Outside. And here's another
maybe
one.
Maybe the atmosphere is.
Here's another really interesting.
He hates squishies, so.
Yeah, here's another really... there wouldn't be any air. Why does he have windows? Anyway, Azimuth.
I got it. Those brain people needed a special atmosphere to live there.
For oxygen?
True. But here's another one. After you destroy Nefarious and Dalton... I said Dalton. Lawrence!
Dalton.
Azimuth comes to the rescue, right? And in the middle of space, opens up his cockpit and screams, "Hey, what?"
I hope in the next Ratchet and Clank game, we find out that this entire time, Lawrence has been the one pulling the strings, and he kills off Nefarious and becomes evil villain himself.
That would be incredible.
So, yeah, there's that one. And then there's another big one, right? Clank's time bombs. Yeah. Right? Notice how he talks about how there's a sonic actuator inside Clank's sister board that allows him to not be affected by time bombs. Right? Except, why the fuck does Ratchet seem unaffected by this?
That's weird.
When he uses time bombs.
It's a gameplay element. It's not supposed to make sense. You sacrifice things in the gameplay for the story.
It's just they couldn't just put like something on his belt or like just something.
Yeah, but it's the same principle. Like in a shooter, like you get shot once in a cutscene and you're dead, but you get shot like a million times in combat.
In the face.
I always think of that is like you're not actually getting shot, they're just missing you by inches, and that's your luck running out.
Yeah, you're getting grazed. Like your health is your luck. Your health is your
luck. Yeah, that's what I see it.
I'm running out of luck. I'm running out of luck.
Give me the luck crate.
Well, in the game Insurgency, like you're like. When you get hit, like your screen blurs, but also when you're being suppressed, when bullets go by you without actually, and when bullets hit near you, you also get that suppressed feeling. But when you actually get hit, like your character like fucking screams out in pain. And if you're wearing armor, you know, you won't die in one shot. And that's your sort of
hilarious that being Uncharted if Drake screamed out in pain every time he got hit with a fucking with a shot.
Oh shit.
But anyway, I went into the Insomniac Museum and I seen Ratchet without his hat.
Yeah. Oh, that would look weird as fuck.
He needs to keep it on. He needs to keep it on. Or he needs to get fucking he needs a haircut.
Show the top of his head. He's a Jew.
If he ever takes that hat thing off, he needs like some spikes or something there, like something like a hairstyle. Because if not, he just looks so weird. He looks so like deformed without his hat.
Guys, I'm going on like 20 hours of being awake. I've been dozing in and out for a little bit.
Okay, no worries. We'll try and speed along. Yeah, so that's games coming up. Am I missing that? I was going to talk about Crash, but I'll talk about that next week because I don't know much about it.
Hey, I'm excited for Crash from what I've seen. And
okay, we'll talk about it then because two people are actually excited. Yeah, Crash Insane Trilogy. Crash Bandicoot is one of my favorite games of all time. One of my favorite game series of all time. Really looking forward to the Insane Trilogy. It does look a bit too bright to me, but they are fixing it because they have been updating the gameplay of it. Or not the gameplay, the graphics of it. And they're adding more dirt and more grunge and shit to it.
That's good.
They're listening to the fans, and that's great. They're doing a great job, and I wish them the best. I hope the game turns out great, and I'll be buying it day one, no matter what, because I want more Crash, and that's Jack.
You going to be doing it one-handed?
No, thank you.
Personally, I'm still, like, in the back of my head, there's still, like, ever-growing hype for The Last of Us 2, and I know I shouldn't let that happen, because if I let it hype up, it's not going to live up to expectations.
Mm-hmm. And the fact that it's going to take years for it to come out and you're not going to want to play anything but that, and you're just going to go into this video game depression.
Exactly that. And I've been hyped for that. Like that's just in the back of my head. Also, Red Dead Redemption 2. I can't wait for that. I know they haven't shown like jack shit about it, like a little teaser, just the tip. But isn't it? I'm pretty sure it's coming out this year.
It's end of this year. Although Rockstar have recently, every time they've announced a game, like GTA 4, GTA 5.
Twice.
So.
Yeah, that's right.
We'll see though. Hopefully, I mean, Rockstar are insane. They release two games every fucking 7 years, and they can fucking live off that. It's insane.
Oh yeah, no, they could have released GTA 5 completely for free, just with the money that they've made from the multiplayer. And I love the Western setting. I think it's an interesting time in history. I think there's a lot of like for Europeans, like the whole medieval era is like where you guys get your like fantasy stories and things like that. But for Americans, it's the Wild West. It's the frontier. You know what I mean?
I personally fucking hate cowboys. I know a bit of a killjoy with that. I never got it. You know, I haven't watched many Westerns either.
Maybe that's your problem.
Well, that's that, Nick. Yeah. You go watch some Clint Eastwood films now. And not
Oh, Rantor God. Can I just stick with the one with his Magnum? With his Magnum, and he's just, like, talking about it. He's like, you feel lucky, punk. Can I just stick to that one, please?
He's a cop in that one. Not even a fucking, like, Westerner.
Exactly! Because fuck cowboys and everything they represent.
Anyway, we better move on before Jackalus falls asleep. Next segment, are you ready for this? Are you ready for this? Are you excited for this? All right.
Excited. Yeah.
Upcoming games on dead consoles.
Oh, I'm excited.
All right. So we're going to start with the good old Wii U, the poor old Wii U that could have done so much better, but Nintendo were like, oh, it's not selling, let's give up, oh no. Okay, how many games do you think are coming out for the remainder of 2017 for the Wii U?
Well, considering the console had like 10 games like its entire life, I'm going to go higher than Nick. I'm going to say like 12.
Okay. Nick, how about you?
5.
Well, Nick was closer.
Ooh.
There are 7 games coming out for the Wii U. I'd want to hear these games, right? Antipole DX is a platformer published by Saturnin Games, and it's coming out Q1 2017, so their release date is soon. Next one, Mousecraft Director's Cat. Oh my god. It's a puzzle game published by Curve Digital, and that release date is soon as well.
Oh shit, hold on. Keith, you know did you ever play the Goku's Legacy and Boo's Fury on GBA?
No.
Dude, those are some of the best fucking...
Yeah, he needs to play those. I can't believe I completely forgot about those. Keith, can you get those?
Yeah, I can get those.
I follow the Facebook of the development studio, and they've been posting they're working on on either a fourth game or just remastering all three of them and bringing them up to modern standards.
Hey, if they're doing another one after that, is it going to be like a Dragon Ball Super one, or
they haven't said what they're going to do. They've just said it won't be GT.
Damn it! No love for GT. God damn it!
Okay, that's nice. So yeah, Director's Cat is coming out soon. Heart Fort Alicia is an action adventure game. Publisher is not available.
Could you imagine being like a small game studio and you're just working so hard on
On a Wii U game.
And, you know, it's getting delayed a few times, but that's okay because you're going to get it out. And it's a Wii U game. And then by the time you're ready to release it, a new console.
Yeah, that's coming out Q2 2017. Ultimate Chicken Horse.
What a name, Ultimate. Where's the sequel to Bible Adventures?
It's coming. Ultimate Chicken Horse is a party game published by Clever Endeavor Games. It's coming out Q3 2017. Super Doomed and Damned for the Wii U is an action game. It's by ArcGen Games, and it's coming out to be decided in 2017. Super Star Soldier is a shooter by Hudson Soft, coming out to be decided in 2017. And finally, the swan song for the Wii U for 2017, according to this. Flying Warriors is an action game by Culture Brain, coming out to be decided in 2017. Every single one of these are indie games.
Feel bad for them.
Tiny little indie games. And that's that for the Wii U.
Do you think there's like hipster game developers that are like, I'm so cool, I developed for the old console, bro.
The thing is, the homebrew scene is really picking up on the Wii U. So there's going to be a fuckload of homebrew games coming out soon. It's going to be cool. And Wii U hacking scene is completely taken off and it's blowing up at the moment, which is great.
Fair enough.
Next, PlayStation 3. How many games do you think are coming after PlayStation 3?
Oh, jeez. Can I guess how many are coming out for the PlayStation 2?
I think you can guess that too easily.
For the PS3, I'm going to say like 15.
Okay, Nick?
72.
72? Wow. The correct answer is 7.
Wow!
Yeah. 7 games in 2017.
Are they all Japanese games?
Well, we will see now. First one is Space Overlords for the PlayStation 3. It's an action game published by Nerge Games, and it's coming out Q1 2017, so they better get their arses ready. Oh, okay. Persona 5 is coming out on PS3. That's going to be the last big PS3 game, I think. So Persona 5, published by Sega, coming out on April 4th, 2017, day after WrestleMania. No, two days after WrestleMania. Guilty Gear Xrd Revelator 2 is a fighting game by Arc System Works, coming out to be decided in 2017. Utaramano Mask of Deception is an adventure game published by Sega. Got all Sega, keeping up the CS3, coming out Q2 2017.
I don't know why they're doing this.
Neither do I. It's
because I mean
PS3 is dead.
Yeah, I mean the production of PS3s in Japan recently stopped.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Revenant Saga is an RPG. It's published by Kemco. Good. Kemco are still around. Holy shit! Did not know that. Probably won't be for much longer if I keep making games for fucking PS3. and that's coming out to be decided in 2017. Oh, wow, Telltale. Marvel's Guardians of the Galaxy, a Telltale game series, is coming out on the PS3 to be decided in 2017. Holy shit.
Jeez.
And FIFA 18, because it's FIFA.
Who plays FIFA anymore? No, I'm playing. I know a lot of people play FIFA.
No. Go outside and play a real game.
Ew.
Cooties. And that's that segment. Anyone shocked by that, or is that just to be a...
I'd be more shocked if Nick told me he didn't masturbate to trap anime porn.
Well, Nick, are you going to shock us?
He kind of blipped out. Can you repeat that?
No, I'd be. Please don't. Let's move on. So, yeah, that's that. Just thought that'd be an interesting segment to do. Let's move on to the final segment of the week on the longest episode yet of Saturday Night Soundbite. And it's the clickbait article of the week, which was mysteriously missing from last week's episode because I deleted it because I was unhappy with the segment. But this week we have a very interesting one. Are you ready for this, lads? I'm going to need your cooperation for this special clickbait article of the week.
Gotcha.
Whew, you got I'm me. Ready.
All right, this is a clickbait article from BuzzFeed. Good old BuzzFeed. And it is a quiz. Would you share these makeup products, or is that gross? In these scenarios, you can't clean or wipe the products before using them. All right, you ready for this, lads? Would you share an eyelash curler? Your options are, sure, it's not gross, or no, that's kind of disgusting.
Okay, well, I'm going to be... I'm going to try to be as sanitary as possible here. Let's think about the types of crustaceans that show up on your eyes.
I'd say no to that straight off. I don't need to look at this at all. Eyes have infections. Eyes can easily catch infections. You fucking put that in an infected eye, you put that in your eye, you have that infection, mate. You're probably going to go blind tomorrow. I say,
yeah,
this no. Carter, like, I think that's a definite no. Anyone have any objections to that?
Yeah, no, no, I agree with you.
Yeah. Okay, no for that.
Apparently we're finding out that we're more into cosmetology.
This is going to shock you. Do you know, 32% of people said no. 68% said sure.
I mean, it is BuzzFeed. It is BuzzFeed. So.
I guess. All right. Oh, here we go. Mascara.
I use a ton of that.
Your options are yes, sounds fine to me, or absolutely fucking not.
Oh, yeah, absolutely sure. Sounds fine to me.
That goes on your eyes as well.
Yeah, again, it's eyes. It's an eye thing.
Where's the guy liner?
Guy liner.
Why do I have, like, an image of latex just lining the and boy's outline? But, yeah, I'm going to say no to that. Anyone have any objections?
No.
45% said, yep, sounds fine, but 55% said, absolutely fucking not. What's the difference between eyeliner and...
I don't know. People are fucking stupid. Continue.
Women are weird. Oh my god, are we still on the eyes? Eyeliner pencil, no.
No.
Skip all the eye questions from now on.
Just say no on all those.
63% of people said no. 37% said sure, why not?
What the hell is wrong with people? Jesus Christ.
Oh my god. Eyeshadow. Fuck off.
Oh my goodness.
No.
12% of people said no. What? 88% said yeah, fuck you.
If you asked me beforehand, I would think that all of these things did the same thing.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. All right. Here we go. Lipstick. Now, this one's controversial.
Ooh, I don't give a fuck. You ever share chapstick with somebody? Basically, yeah, exactly. The same concept.
I mean, unless you have a cold sore, I think it's fine. And cold sores are really obvious to know if you have one or not. So like, it's if like. So I say all right. I think
they don't know if you're rubbing chapstick on your dick though.
But true, but like, as long as you. It's,
what if you have a cold sore on your dick? Which part makes it bad? The cold sore or it being on your dick?
I don't think that's too bad. I mean, it won't damage you in any way. If it was there, it would just, like, smell weird.
True, true.
So, I don't know.
I'm going to say sure to that. What about you, Nick?
Well, me and Jack, we live in America. A lot of sluts. A lot of people of all sorts, shapes, and sizes, and we're not really the most sanitary bunch. I would have to say no. Because I'd be afraid of getting fucking herpes on my fucking face.
It's a I understand, but it's I vote 2-1, so fuck you, Nick. Oh, right. My god, this is 50-50. Completely 50-50. Interesting. I don't believe that, by the way. BuzzFeed are lying. Makeup brushes. Yeah, that's fine, I think.
I would assume. That would be all right, I guess. I mean, unless they're, you got, like, fucking skin cancer and it's fucking...
Contagious.
Yeah.
Jack, any objections to that, to our vote?
No.
Yeah, that's fine. I think that's fine. Let's see what the girls think. 38% said yeah.
The fact that you're assuming that it's just girls doing this.
62% said no. Well, but you said yes to eye pencils? What?
They're stupid. Fuck, they're just stupid. Just keep going.
Okay, lip liner. I don't even know what the fuck that is.
It's like to around, it's not like on the lips, it's like around the circumference of the lips. It's really stupid.
Oh my fucking god.
I'm just gonna say no.
Why does this shit exist?
I'm just gonna say no, because the other one.
I'll say no, too.
Okay, and by vote, so let's say no. 45% said yeah, definitely. 55% said no, so you win. Eye primer, what is with the eye shit? What is eye primer, actually?
No.
Who knows?
Eye primer. It looks... What the fuck is eye primer?
The only thing I can think of when I think of primer is, like, taking a fucking weed whacker and, like, fucking sticking your thumb into the fucking side of it to get the fucking oil to fucking lubricate the gears of it.
I'm realizing something by doing this. Why does half of this shit exist? It's all pretty much the exact same product.
That's what it's I just thought. Fucking
minerals on your face.
I'm going to say no to that because it's an eye thing. 16% said no. 84% said yes.
What the fuck? Unless it's like something that you like dab in your finger and like... I don't fucking do makeup. I fucking wear clown makeup for fuck's sake.
If any of you can say what this is, I'm going to assume you're a transvestite. A concealer.
What?
What the fuck is
this? Does it like conceal things?
Spell it.
Let me look this up. Let me look those. Concealer.
I have no idea what the fuck that is.
What is a concealer? Oh my god, Google doesn't have the answers! What is a concealer? Concealer, a flesh-toned cosmetic stick used to cover spots, blemishes, and dark under-eye circles. Okay.
Okay, considering that's all over your face all the time...
And it's covering up fucking spots and contagious herpes? I'd say no.
Yeah, no, no.
Yeah, no.
No. Oh my god. 62% said sure.
Oh!
What is wrong with you people? Do you think?
Next time I talk to a girl, the first thing I'm going to ask her is, I'm going to say, do you ever do BuzzFeed quizzes? And if she says yes, I'm going to fucking dropkick her and like, and give her a fucking female circumcision.
Well, that's that. That's the BuzzFeed. Very so productive BuzzFeed.
So what did we rate? Are we gross or no?
No, it doesn't say it, and it just gives us the things. We disagreed with most of them. But we can look at the ratings. So 13% of people rated this BuzzFeed article WTF. Seven people rated this article LOL. Seven people rated this article Love Heart. 4 people rated this article Broken Love Heart. 3 people rated this article OMG. 1 person rated this article Fail. 1 person rated this article Win. And no one rated this article Q.
You should rate it Fail.
It's disgusting.
I'm going to rate a Q. Yes, 1. I'm the 1. Fucking hell, this site. I think I'm going to make this... let's do a BuzzFeed quiz every week, should we? I find that fun. Whatever. That's the episode for today, my friend. Saturday Night Senpai is nearly over, and we're sad.
I have to watch fucking Lord of the Rings after this.
The director's cut with DJ.
Don't you have to watch the director's cut? I don't.
Well, yeah.
Here's the thing about Lord of the Rings. I don't really like the director's cut of it.
I know we've covered this.
No, it ruins the flow for me. It ruins the fucking pacing of the film. Especially in 2, and 2 is most noticeable, right? In 2, you have the big battle and all, and that battle flows so nicely, between the tree branch and storylines and the two towers. And then, in the director's cut, it just adds in these random scenes that have nothing to do with fucking anything, that just ruins the entire flow of the battle, and that does my head in. But yeah, I don't like the director's cut of Lord of the Rings, I'm sorry.
The first one was really bad. It was good. The director cut is really good, but they cut out so many important things. They cut out fucking Legolas getting his bow, fucking Aragorn getting his fucking little knife, fucking Frodo getting his stick thing, his fucking flashlight, Sam getting the rope.
Flashlight?
Yeah, his medieval flashlight, the fucking star. They cut out that shit. They cut out the fucking ring and Gandalf screaming at the ring on the pedestal and shit. If I didn't read the book, I would have been what? Wow, how could they cut and the normal film makes Boromir look like a complete asshole. But when you look at the director's cut, he's actually not a fucking bad guy at all.
Wanting the two towers? Oh, no, not the two towers. Return of the King is that they cut out fucking Saruman's death. What the fuck? Why do you cut that out? That's a vital part of the story. He just disappears in the normal version.
Well, we'd like to thank all our loyal viewers for sticking with us. We'd like to thank all our loyal viewers for sticking with us this long and letting us pleasure your ears.
Alright, this is
Saturday Night Soundbite episode 3, my friends. Thank you for listening. I hope you enjoyed. I'm gonna play you out to a catchy 80s theme here, and yeah, have a good week. Enjoy your life,
y'all.
Keep safe and use protection. Goodbye, always. My friends.